a Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty. And there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time.
Blog Talk Radio.
This is True Capitalist Radio. True Capitalist Radio.
I am your host, the man they call Ghost.
The badass of business.
Give him capitalism or give him death.
That's it. Period.
Broadcasting from his Skyline Office Studios in beautiful downtown Austin, Texas.
You sound fruitier than a box of Fruit Loops, for Christ's sake.
And now, he'll take it from here. Your host, the prognosticator of prognosticators, the man they call Ghost.
What's going on, folks? And thank you for tuning in with me to another edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And, of course, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, folks, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. This is episode number 341. Number 341 for all the folks that are keeping track of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And before I get into anything else, I'd like for everybody to please spread it around like wildfire and let everybody know that True Capitalist Radio is in effect and in the house, and we are live right now on this Taco Tuesday. And, of course, we're live every Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time is when you can tune in with us live. And, of course, the official website, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. That's blogtalkradio.com/ghost. And, of course, folks, if you haven't already done so, please follow me on Twitter, all right? The Twitter name to follow, PoliticsGhost, all one word, no underscores, PoliticsGhost. All right, folks, let's go ahead and get right into the nitty-gritty, folks. I'm just going to go over a few subject matters today. And then I'm going to go ahead and open up the phone lines on a spontaneous free-format Taco Tuesday edition. And I'm going to open up the phone lines, and I'm going to discuss whatever you want to discuss on this edition. Of course, we're going to have the regular festivities, Twitter shout-outs, and, of course, radio graffiti. So without any further ado, I want to talk about the first subject matter at hand. And what did I tell you, Alex Jones, what I've been saying about Alex Jones, okay? I've been saying ever since Hillary Rotten Clinton said his name out of her disgusting, ulcerated tongue mouth, it was going to be some serious business for Alex Jones. And in my personal opinion, folks, I think that Alex Jones is starting to feel the heat, to say the least, as it relates to the attention that he is getting now from Hillary Clinton and now the Clinton crime family. All right? Now, I don't know, folks, if you were following me last evening. Last evening, I tweeted a article that was published that day, as a matter of fact, yesterday, I believe it was the 29th, in which Infowars.com has reportedly been hacked, and its user database of 50,000 is available on the dark web somewhere. And if you want my personal opinion, folks, this has a lot to do with the Hillary Clinton mention or the name drop of Alex Jones. I'm telling you this right now. This is cyber warfare at this point in time, just by the chain of events that has happened. It seems to me that you've got the Democrats, the liberals, or should I say the bureaucratic institutionalists, the political class. These sons of bitches are now starting to play fire with fire. And in my personal opinion, I believe, and this is, of course, from my variety of sources, and you know me, folks, I know my way around these internets, for Christ's sake, all right? Hold on a second. I'm getting sidetracked here. What's going on? The show isn't broadcasting on the freaking Blog Talk radio site? What's going on here? Am I just broadcasting to myself? This is what we're going to do again, for Christ's sake? I'm tired of this. Folks, if you're having trouble with the stream, please tweet at Blog Talk Radio. They're actually fairly decent about responding to grievances. I got to give them that. So if for whatever reason, no one is able to, for whatever reason, get the Blog Talk Radio stream, for Christ's sake, you know, there's a couple of other places. As a matter of fact, some of the people from the inner circle, here's the Brony Network, all right, it has a stream out here where it streams. I just retweeted that. I cannot believe that we're having issues with the damn Blog Talk Radio Network. You know what I'm hoping? I'm hoping that it's just so goddamn, so many people. There's so many goddamn people. Okay, it's working again. All right. All right, here we go. Sorry. I'm sidetracked over here. I'm sorry. So anyway, folks, let me go ahead. I believe it is working again. All right. Of course, if you don't have the stream for whatever reason, there's a YouTube stream right there so everybody can listen to. Of course, I don't know what's going on in the damn chat room over there. I know there's a bunch of you know, people, haters, and, you know, appreciators alike in that chat room. So I don't know what the hell's going on. Anyway, folks, I hope that Blog Talk's technical issues are able to go ahead and, kind of rectify themselves, to say the least, because by God, all right? I mean, how many times does yours truly have to be censored, for Christ's sake, all right? I mean, you know that the last time they tried to censor me was in episode 320, which I do feature on my website, folks, blogtalkradio.com/ghost, all right? I featured this on my on that particular website because the episode 320, they attempted to censor, all right? That was the episode in which I was describing how if motivated individuals wanted to take control of the government, I laid down the blueprint for it, all right? Anyway, once again, Blog Talk Radio is not working, folks, all right? I hope everybody is able to find, I think it's censorship. I don't know what the hell's going on, all right? I mean, come on, man. I mean, what do I, man, I got thousands of people over here that want to listen, for Christ's sake. I got thousands of people. God damn it, they're sitting over here, they're ruining my damn broadcast. I can't work like this. You understand it? I can't work like this. Look at this. Look at, God damn it. Oh my God. What a joke. I can't work like this. I'm up here every day, for Christ's sake, man. I mean, the least that these people can do is goddamn provide a service that freaking works. Oh, Jesus Christ. Give me the mic. Give me the mic. Jesus Christ. Well, I wanted to talk about Alex Jones and how the poor bastard is begging Hillary Clinton not to kill him. But here I am. I'm dealing with damn technical issues, and it's pissing me off. I mean, hey, Blog Talk, don't you understand that what I'm doing here is Internet Hall of Fame broadcasting, goddammit? It's Internet Hall of Fame broadcasting, for Christ's sake, man. They're going to give me the golden microphone of broadcasting in about 20 years for this crap. Hey, look at you people. Look at you. You're trying to silence me. I'm tired of it, man. I'm tired of it. Oh, my God. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm pissed off. This is pissing me off. This has thrown the goddamn show into a whole new arena, for Christ's sake. Jesus Christ, man. Anyway, look, I'm going to continue on with the show, but I can't work like this. Do you understand that? I can't work like this, man. Good God, man. Anyway, folks, I'm sorry if you're having technical difficulties, all right? My apologies, all right? I'm sincere. My apologies, for Christ's sake, man. Jesus Christ. I'm not joking, man. You know, I'm sitting over here. I'm up here every day, all right? I'm up here every goddamn day, for Christ's sake. And here they are. They're just, I hope that it's just some kind of technical difficulty or some kind of goddamn glitch. Wink, wink. But by God, I'm getting a little bit tired of this. I'm saying this. I'm going to say it again. I can't work like this, man. I'm a professional. All right? I'm a professional here. I mean, Jesus Christ, man. Good God. I mean, just, you know what? Give me my belt. Give me this goddamn belt. Give it. God damn it. I'm going to take you to the woodshed, BTR. All right? You better get your goddamn crap together. All right? You understand that, BTR? I'm a professional here, man. All right? What I'm doing is internet freaking Hall of Fame broadcasting it, for Christ's sake. And I wish you appreciated that. Jesus Christ. I wish you sons of bitches appreciated it. I just get no appreciation around here. I get no appreciation, no respect. Freaking, take that, boy. You take that, BTR. You take that. Son of a bitch. I'm telling you this right now. All right, I'm sorry. I think BTR's back. I'm sorry. You see, you got to take these sons of bitches to the woodshed. You see, now I'm getting tweets that it's okay. Now I'm getting tweets that people are getting the goddamn broadcast in BTR now, huh? I mean, you see what you have to do, folks? You see what you have to do to be a real man, to tell everybody, to show everybody that you mean goddamn business? You take them to the damn woodshed if you need to, boy. You understand that? You're goddamn right, boy. Jesus Christ, I didn't even expect to go through all that spectacle, so really the broadcast, for Christ's sake, but I deserve more respect. Jesus Christ, give me my drink. Give me my goddamn drink. Anyway, folks, let me calm my ass down now, for Christ's sake, after I took BTR to the woodshed, boy. After I took BTR to the damn woodshed, boy. I'm telling you this right now. All right, let me calm my ass down. My apologies, folks. I was trying to get into Alex Jones and the poor bastard begging Hillary Clinton to spare his life. And here we got Blog Talk Radio having technical difficulties and me throwing around my manly dominance all across this internet like it ain't crap. I had to take these sons of bitches into the damn woodshed and whoop some digital ass. Alright? Jesus Christ. I'm glad everybody's able to get the damn stream going on. I don't know what the hell's going on. I hope that it's because there's so many damn people. So many damn people that actually want to listen to the broadcast that we are just clogging that server. We are just juicing that bandwidth, boy. I'm serious, man. I'm telling you. I mean, with all due respect, you notice that they promote other podcasts on my podcast. I mean, they're even promoting Jim Brewer's podcast, for Christ's sake, man. I mean, just that's what I'm doing here. I just wish I had some appreciation, for Christ's sake. Hey, by the way, hey, Jim Brewer, you know, since I'm plugging your show on my damn show podcast, why don't you come along over here and maybe give us an interview, for Christ's sake? How about that, goat boy? Huh? Yeah. Jesus Christ. Anyway, let me go ahead and calm my ass down, folks. I'm sorry. I got off keister very early in the broadcast. I'm not used to doing this. You know what I'm saying? But by God, man, if it's not one thing, it's another, man. It's not one goddamn thing, it's another. Anyway, I was talking about Alex Jones, this poor son of a bitch. I mean, now that Hillary Rotten Clinton mouthed off and name-dropped his name, for Christ's sake, InfoWars is getting hacked. Alex Jones is getting some kind of signals from, outside sources. Haven't you noticed this son of a bitch? I haven't seen him live in the past couple of days. This guy's been hiding in a bunker somewhere because this poor son of a bitch is scared crapless. I mean, not that I blame him, all right? Not that I blame you, Alex, all right? Because let me tell you, right when Hillary Clinton said this, that was the first thing I said. I said, man, if I were Alex Jones, I wouldn't be patting myself on the back for Hillary Rodham Clinton saying my name. I'd be heading for cover, man, all right? I'd be having food tasters. I'm serious. I wouldn't want to be left alone. You know what I mean? I'd wear like thick clothing. So if they, try to shoot some heart attack dart into your body, you can at least have a couple of layers to, attempt to try to stop such a thing, for Christ's sake. They got these psychotronic, weapons, for Christ's sake, that make you go insane, which, I don't think Alex Jones is too far off of, in some instances, not all instances, but still, I'm just saying, I really thought that, it was a bad deal for Alex Jones to have his name out of the mouth of Hillary Clinton, and now he's starting to realize it, folks, and I tweeted this morning on my Twitter account, Politics Ghost, Alex Jones begs Hillary Clinton not to kill him, and that's pretty sad. I mean, that's just... I mean, not for Alex Jones. I don't blame him. I mean, nobody wants to freaking die because Hillary Rotten Clinton out here is just so bloodthirsty and disgusting and her quest for power. She'll just kill anybody and anything, for Christ's sake. Oh, my God. It's horrible, man. It's horrible. It's horrible. Anyway, Alex, all I've got to say is, stay safe and take comfort in knowing if anything does happen to you, everyone knows that it's going to be Hillary Rotten Clinton. And moreover, I think they'd be doing themselves a disservice if they decided to off you because you'd become a damn martyr. You know what I mean? I mean, that's what inspired Texas to continue fighting against Santa Ana was the Texas martyrs that died at the Alamo, boy. And every time the Texas Revolutionary Guard out here, or the Texas Revolutionaries were out here fighting the Mexicans and Santa Ana's army, every time after the Battle of the Alamo, they'd be screaming, "Remember the Alamo! Remember the Alamo!" And I'm talking about the Battle of Goliad. I'm talking about the Battle of San Jacinto. You understand that? I'm talking about the Battle of Victoria. I'm a Texan, boy. I have lineage to the Texas martyrs. I have lineage to the Texas martyrs. So that's why I'm saying, Alex, in my personal opinion, man, stay safe. If you got to be in a bunker and broadcast in some kind of spider hole, I don't blame you, all right? I'm serious. I don't blame you. But as far as I'm concerned, you need to make sure that your operation continues to operate as a well-oiled machine. Ever since Hillary Rotten Clinton mouthed off and dropped your name, it seems to me, I'm just saying, I mean, I'm trying to take my opinion with a grain of salt, but the production in some aspects has lagged a little, and the content for which you put out, it could be a little bit more tastier. It could be a little bit better considering the production quality and the capability that you have at your disposal. All right, that's all I'm saying. Anyway, folks, another thing I did want to talk about here before I start taking phone calls here is I wanted to talk a little bit about this general that came out here today. And I don't know. Well, let me put it to you like this. I know why he said it. But if you're just some regular, everyday American citizen who's believing these talking heads on the boob tube, you wouldn't know why in the hell he said it. But a top U.S. general said here on Taco Tuesday that ISIS fighters defied their leader, Baghdadi, all right, Baghdadi is his name, in a recent battle because Baghdadi announced that the ISIS fighters that are under his command should fight to the death. And they decided to retreat like a bunch of bitches. Now, folks, haven't I been saying this about, first of all, these ISIS fighters, that these ISIS fighters are all a bunch of punks? Moreover, there's footage all over the internet of the Peshmerga, the Kurds, capturing these damn ISIS sons of bitches in the middle of battle, and they're crying like a bunch of pussies. I mean, just completely crying, breaking down. I mean, they're just scared. These are the same people that are beheading innocent children, beheading women, throwing homosexuals off buildings, for Christ's sake. That's why I'm saying that.
A Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty. And there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time.
That's why I'm saying that, folks. Anyway, this general, why would he even be announcing this? I mean, if we are fighting ISIS, wink, wink, why in the hell would we care if the ISIS soldiers defied their leader Baghdadi's orders to fight to the death and they were treated like a bunch of bitches? Why would we even care? I mean, isn't ISIS our enemy? I mean, isn't that what they've been telling us? Oh, ISIS, we got to move. Oh, ISIS is the enemy. Oh, my God, ISIS, 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 right? Huh? Well, folks, I'm going to tell you why, and I've been saying this time and time again. This ISIS is a CIA operation in conjunction with NATO, the United Nations, a whole bunch of different components, so that nobody has any kind of direct responsibility for the destabilization of the Middle East, all right? And ISIS is basically following the orders of the CIA operatives that are out there. I mean, folks, Jesus Christ, do I have to go through this again? I mean, what was Benghazi? They keep saying that Benghazi was a consulate. Benghazi was not a consulate. All right, it was a CIA outpost to bring in guns from Turkey, bring them in to that outpost from into Benghazi, and from Benghazi they were given out to the operatives and those in conjunction that are running these ISIS operations in the field, all right? And you see, unfortunately for the CIA, they didn't anticipate that the wild Jihudi component that they are rabble-rousing through a variety of different mechanisms of psychological and physical warfare can turn on them at any goddamn time. That's why, folks, the ambassador was there, and he was protected by the CIA. The CIA is not there to protect ambassadors, all right? That ambassador should have been protected by the United States military, and it should have been some level of embassy with barriers and proper security measures to protect this man, all right? But there wasn't, all right? And that's why I'm saying, folks, ISIS is a deliberate creation. When Donald Trump says Obama and Hillary Clinton created ISIS, he's not lying. He's not lying. All right? It's just the fact that the mainstream media is not going to tell you the truth. Now, I know people are going to sit here and say, well, Ghost, that's obnoxious. I mean, ISIS, aren't they killing us or killing Christians? I mean, what are you talking about? Folks, if ISIS is our enemy, why would this general even give a rat's ass that the ISIS fighters defied Baghdadi's orders and retreated, and now Turkey, which I have always said, remember the prognosticator of prognosticators, strikes again. Turkey's moving deeper into Syria. I said they would do this 2 days after that fake coup that was orchestrated by Erdogan, quarterbacked by Putin. I said that Sunday. The coup happened on a Friday. I had a spontaneous Sunday edition, and I said it on that Sunday. And I told you that once Turkey moves right into Syria, it's going to move right into northern Iraq, and the people that have been terrorized by this CIA operation of ISIS are going to greet Turkey as a liberator. As a liberator. They're already doing it, folks. And look, these terrorists, these ISIS fighters, as Muammar Gaddafi said, these are mercenaries. These are people that are getting paid to terrorize. I mean, why do you think that they are properly armed? Why do you think they have proper supplies? You know what I'm saying? I mean, how come they have all this armory and they look like professional soldiers out here? Who gave that to them? NATO, the United States, folks, we gave it to them. And now that Turkey and Russia, now look, you can interpret this how you want. You can interpret this that Turkey and Russia bamboozled the United States and basically kind of pulled the rug from under the Obama administration's foreign policy. But as I've stated, I personally believe that all these actors are complicit with each other. All right? I believe that Obama, Erdogan, Putin, they're all in on this staged nuclear confrontation in an attempt to try to legitimize reasoning to detonate nuclear weapons to wipe out millions of people so that this international bureaucratic institutionalist consortium can finally assert itself as the dominant authority. All right? I'm serious, man. I mean, that's what it's all. That's what it is. I don't believe that Obama got out bamboozled. I think that they are all complicit, man. And as I stated time and time again, Obama has met with Erdogan, Turkey's leader, more times than any other head of state during Obama's presidency. All right, and you mean to tell me that Erdogan was just being chummy with him so that he could bamboozle him at this point in time? Bull crap. All right, bull crap. So that's why I'm saying, folks, this U.S. general coming out and, you know, making it public that ISIS defied orders to fight to the death from their leader, Baghdadi. Why would we care? They're the enemy, right, General? Huh? They're supposed to be the enemy. Why would we care? I mean, wouldn't we be having a party if freaking ISIS is supposedly being slaughtered out here? Shouldn't we be having a party? Aren't these the terrorists that these talking heads on the lamestream, mainstream media are telling us? Aren't these the big bad guys, huh? Folks, this is a CIA operation in conjunction with NATO and other bureaucratic international consortiums. I'm talking Saudi Arabia, all right? You don't think Saudi Arabia has something to do with this crap? Give me a break. Folks, we are living in a time of such destabilization. And the positioning of global conflict. I'm talking world war on a level that we have never even thought about. Remember, World War II killed 65 million people. That was the last major war that anyone in the world has ever seen that has literally created such destruction. And let me tell you, now that we have these nuclear weapons, I mean, the capability of killing millions of people at an instant is just that easy, especially if you're in charge of this place. And if you're in charge of this place and you don't want these people to have freedom anymore and you want to be the exclusive new 21st century elitist class, the corporate political elitist class, well, then, by God, why not try to manage a nuclear war? Why not try to stage this kind of international relations fiasco that history will write was the culmination of World War III when, in my personal opinion, this is all staged. Folks, why do you think I knew all this was going to happen? Am I psychic? Am I lucky? I mean, think about that crap, man! If you are not someone who understands history, then those that know history are going to repeat history. Now, why is that? I'll tell you why, all right? Because if it works, don't fix it. If it's worked before, it'll work again. The more things change, the more they stay the same. And for you people that know nothing about history, this is why you people are completely in the dark about this stuff, all right? That's why y'all are in completely in the damn dark. So open your eyes and wake up, for Christ's sake, man. Jesus Christ. Anyway, folks, I wanted to talk a little bit about that there. I want to hear from you now, all right? Let me go ahead and clear some lines out, engineer. Clear some of these lines. We're going to clear out some of these lines here and see if we can get some people on the horn here. If you want to give us a call right now, go ahead. It is a Taco Tuesday free format edition, baby. All right, we want to hear from you. We're going to talk about whatever you want to talk about. And unfortunately, if we have a bunch of trolls or a bunch of idiot callers or something of that nature, I got a plan B going on. So we'll see what's going on here. 425-390-6146 is the number to call here. All right. Let me go ahead and take a few calls and see what you want to talk about here on this Taco Tuesday. Who do we got? We got 714. You're on the horn. What's going on?
Hey, what's up, Ghost? This is Z Frostwire, man. How are you doing today?
Hey, how you doing, Z Frost, man? How you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good. It's kind of hot today, but I'm glad to see that Blog Talk Radio got your show back on the air. That was weird how they weren't going to let it air to those other people that were listening in.
I have no idea what the hell these people are doing, but, I mean, people have tweeted at Blog Talk Radio. Blog Talk Radio is getting in to seeing what the problem is. I mean, they're pretty fast about that. I'll give that to them. And if there's other technical difficulties, well, I mean, who knows? I mean, remember, I tweeted yesterday that Infowars.com got hacked. 50,000 user database was exposed, and it's available somewhere on the dark web. And if you want my personal opinion, I think that Hillary Clinton and the DNC hired rogue elements within the hacking circles of the internet to do this so that they can have plausible deniability to obtain a list of people who would be probably the first on the list if they ever took power in this next presidency and round up those 50,000 people on that list and put them in a re-education camp, which is literally what the Democratic form of the platform is right now. It's literally Marxist, Maoist garbage. But, I mean,
exactly.
you're absolutely right, man. Go ahead. What were you going to say, man? Sorry about that.
I was going to say, like, you're right about them getting that corrected way faster than a lot of these other internet talk shows. But anyways, I wanted to say that this whole thing with ISIS, man, like, I mean, I knew that they were just going to be a bunch of punks. I mean, they're killing a bunch of people that can't even protect themselves, like, literally if their life depended on it, as we can plainly see. So now that they're being called out about, you know, this fiasco about turning on their leader and things like that, or their leader turning against them and stuff, like, now they're running like a bunch of scared dogs with their tail between their legs. And like,
no, you're absolutely right, Z Frostwire. Let me tell you, I want to reemphasize this. Why is this general even bringing this up? Why should we even care? Shouldn't we be having a party if ISIS is retreating and they're being slaughtered? No, I'm telling you why, because these are CIA assets. And if they're turning and running with their tail between their goddamn wild Jehudi legs, for Christ's sake, the CIA is losing assets. They're losing weaponry. They're losing supplies that they supplied these damn Jehudis. All right? And I'm telling you this right now. Turkey is moving farther into Syria, and they are going to be greeted as liberators because ISIS has been terrorizing the whole goddamn place. I mean, do you think Erdogan knows this? I mean, Erdogan's a pretty smart Turkish kebab. I'm telling you this right now. He's pretty brilliant. And, I mean, now that he's sided himself with Vladimir Putin, it's not a coincidence that he's making these moves. All right? It's not a coincidence that he's making these moves, for Christ's sake, man. Anyway, you want to give any shout-outs there, Z Frost?
Yeah, I wanted to give a shout-out to the whole Capitalist Army. Wanted to give a shout-out to you and the engineer. You guys are doing a great job on this internet and doing a great job with the True Capitalist Radio. And I hope I can stick around for both Radio Graffiti and possibly a third hour.
Yeah, man, go ahead. I'll leave you on hold right there. Thank you very much for tuning in. I appreciate your contribution to this free format Taco Tuesday edition. Let's continue going, shall we? We're opening up the phone lines here. And look, if it's busy, folks, my apologies. Keep trying. You know, this is the unfortunate byproduct of being on the internet and a lot of people listening, you know, 50-plus thousand people listening live on a consistent basis. So, anyway, who else do we got here? 562, what's up? You're on the horn on Taco Tuesday.
Just want to say that I've got a heart on if Templeton needs a seat.
Hey, do you live with your parents? No. Call that asshole back. Call him back. All right? You're going to sit over here and you're going to, you know, act like some stupid little fruit bowl. All right? Call his ass back. I'm sick of this crap. I mean, look, if you're going to sit here and do a prank call, why don't you make one that's freaking funny, for Christ's sake, man? Give me a break. Call that stupid little fruity ass back. Jesus Christ. Call him back.
Have reached.
What? Oh, come on. Are you there? Or did you hang up? Oh, he hung up. Oh, call him back.
You have reached the voicemail box of 562212411.
I'm going to call him one more again. All right, one more again.
You have reached the voicemail box of 562212419.
Oh! You stupid little fruit bowl. All right? Zero, okay? Anyway, let's move on, shall we? All right, how about 951? You're on the horn on this Taco Tuesday.
Hey, Ghost, how you doing, man?
How you doing?
Have you heard about that signal they're picking up from space? They're thinking that's possibly extraterrestrials. What do you think about that?
I think it's a bunch of horse crap. That's what I think it is, all right? I think it's the biggest bunch of crap. I don't believe in this alien crap. I don't even believe we've been to space! All right, I don't even want to talk about space. I don't want to talk about NASA. You know, you idiots understand that NASA was headed up by the rocket man, Wernher von Braun, which was the Nazis' rocket scientist that was able to come across into the United States in Operation Paperclip, and he became the head of NASA. Yeah, Wernher von Braun. All right, look it up for yourself. All right, the man who was making rockets for Hitler was the guy who was the leader and the head of NASA for like 30 years. So let me tell you something. I don't believe a goddamn thing any of these people, all right? All right, any of these freaking people are saying, oh, look, there's an alien signal. Here it is, an alien signal. Here it is. Oh, what is it saying? What is it saying? Oh, it's saying something. I know it. I know it says it. Give me a break. I mean, you know that it's a radio signal that these idiots are getting. You understand this, right? Do you even know how radio signals work? I know. I bet you have no idea how radio signals work. You know that there's invisible conduits called radio waves that are floating around in the sky, folks. We don't know why they're there. We just know they're there and know how to use them. I kid you not. I kid you not. Now, there's two kinds of radio waves, folks. There's, you know, the traditional line of sight radio wave in which there's a tower that's, releasing a signal, and that signal is getting a direct line of sight to some receiver to some capacity. And then there is bouncing radio waves, which, believe it or not, that's how the old school radios from like the 20s and the 30s used to capture their audio from, was these bouncing radio waves. Believe it or not, if you use these radio waves that literally bounce from, you know, it's not line of sight, all right? It bounces up into the ionosphere, down, back to, the ground state, and it goes back up, and literally it continues doing that. Now, I kid you not, folks, if you get yourself an old school radio and you put it on, you can actually capture some of these old school radio waves that were broadcasted during that time and actually capture old school broadcasts. I'm not kidding around. All right. I mean, there are broadcasts that are still bouncing around in these radio waves that you can capture under these, you know, certain frequencies, antennas, so on and so forth. So, I mean, in my personal opinion, all right, I don't believe it. I don't believe a goddamn thing any of these people are saying at all. I think it's garbage. Jesus Christ. And, hey, here's El Foxo Loco. Thank you very much for the tweet here. Russian aircraft near Ukraine's borders have been put on two-minute readiness alert. Oh, there you go, huh? Oh, that's just great, isn't it? I mean, wasn't I just talking about damn Russia and Turkey and how Russia and Putin are quarterbacking Turkey's moves, for Christ's sake? Look at this. They're making a move now. You idiots. I'm telling you, you idiots will rue the day when you thought I was a bunch of crap, when millions of people are killed in a nuclear situation. You people will rue the day. I can guarantee you that right now. You understand that? You people will rue the day. Jesus Christ. Let me go ahead and take a swig of this beer. Cheers to everybody out there. Cheers. And speaking of radio waves, folks, we need to take out FM and maybe not AM radio. I still like AM radio. FM radio needs to go. All right, seriously. We could utilize those radio waves for so much better usage than to sit here and to listen to the regurgitation of nothing but stupid-ass, same old song crap, man. I mean, anyway, that's a whole other subject matter. I don't believe in aliens. I think it's a bunch of garbage, all right? I mean, if you believe in aliens, then, you know, to be honest with you, you got some problems, all right? Seriously, all right? And if there is anything UFO-related, and I'm sure there are UFOs. I've seen very good footage of UFOs. I personally believe it has everything to do with terrestrial testing, weaponry, things that they're not even telling us, for Christ's sake, all right? You don't even know what our government knows. Anyway, let's move on, all right? Who else do we have here? We've got area code 309. You're on the horn. What's up, man?
Hey, Ghost, how you doing on Taco Tuesday, mate?
Hey, how you doing? It's Jimmy Capitalist, man. How you doing? It's good to hear from you.
Yeah, I'm doing pretty good, man. I'm off work all week on holiday, enjoying the sun. Surprisingly for Ireland, it's not fucking raining for once, you know.
No kidding. I hear that in the UK it's actually rather pleasant out here. We're experiencing, unfortunately, a whole bunch of weird tropical storms on the Atlantic, weird stuff happening on the Gulf. You got things even on the other side of Mexico in the Pacific Baja region. So it's pretty weird, man. So, you know, lucky you guys out there in Britannia or in the UK, you know, having some pretty good weather.
Yeah, man, I can attest to you saying that the weather's a bit weird at the minute. I mean, this has been a pretty awkward summer. I mean, it's been wet flat out all summer, 2 months of almost nonstop rain. Temperatures, you guys work in Fahrenheit, but the temperature's barely reaching 20 degrees Celsius, whereas last summer we were getting, you know, 30, 35 degrees Celsius and shit like that. So, I mean, it is really weird.
I mean, it does, and I'll put it like this. It could be a potential cycle, a weird weather cycle. I mean, you know, I like how these damn scientists believe that they know how and why all this is happening, even though geological digs that we've done through a variety of different methods, including of which digging for oil, the sediment and how it's compacted has shown us that, you know, we've had ice ages, we've had floods, we've had pole reversals, we've had volcanic activity. I mean, you know, through the eons of years, a lot of things have happened on whatever this place is, with this planet, whatever it is. So, you know, for these scientists to believe that they actually know what's going on is utterly ridiculous. And look, if we're going to talk about Russian hackers, I can tell you that it was the Russian hackers that were the ones that hacked the emails from these global warming scientists where they were laughing about, you know, inflating data and so on and so forth. So anyway, I didn't mean to get off on that tirade, but, you know, we were discussing the environment, we're discussing the weather, and I know that there's going to be some crackpipe listening to this claiming that, well, you see, it's global warming. So I just wanted to discredit that crap.
Yeah, man. You know, I didn't actually have any intention of talking about weather when I come up here, but, you know, did you happen to see that cloud in Siberia the other day that these scientists tried passing off as some spontaneous, you know, microburst cloud or some shit? You know, that shit.
No, I did not see that. What was that about? Enlighten us there, Jimmy.
Well, I'm going to read it at you, man. There was this cloud which strangely resembled almost perfectly the mushroom cloud of Anuk. I believe it was in Russia. It was definitely in the Siberian region. And all these people tried coming out and stating that it was some, you know, special formed cloud, all this nonsense. Yeah, I don't believe that kind of shit. I believe
I'm
Russia
looking at it right now. I'm looking at it right now, Jimmy. It looks like a goddamn mushroom cloud if I've ever seen one. Especially in Siberia, that'd be a perfect area to conduct some nuclear testing of some capacity. And look, we are on the brink of a nuclear confrontation with Russia. This would be a easy way to show the world that, hey, Russia is willing to drop the bomb. And, you know, this does not look like some special formated cloud. That's ridiculous if they're going to pass that off as that. It's a really scary, ominous-looking mushroom cloud. I mean, you couldn't get – it looks like a damn mushroom, for Christ's sake, man. No, I didn't see that, Jimmy. I'm really glad that you brought that to our attention here. I mean, once again, there's so many things going on in the world today. What's going on? I mean, it's unbelievable.
Yeah, you're exactly right, man. There's so much stuff happening now, and I've just got to laugh. They keep trying to lie to our faces. They keep coming out with all this nonsense. Look at Germany, for example. That dumbass bitch in power that is Angela Merkel saying, "Oh, all these people are so horrible. You know, all these refugees, they're subjected to such horrible conditions, and these people are coming in and butchering the whole of Europe." You know, I'm just fed up with being lied to. You know, that's why I come up and listen to your broadcast. I want to hear the truth. You know.
Absolutely, and I try to give the unadulterated truth as often as I can. I mean, look, the internet freedom is right around the corner. The ceasing of internet freedom is right around the corner. Obama's going to give our internet to the United Nations on October 1st, and I think people need to start realizing how serious this is, because there's not going to be any more freedom of speech. These trolls, they think that they're going to continue trolling and it's going to be memes and, you know, having fun and laughing and doing all this crap. That's not how it's going to work anymore. I mean, now that the United Nations is going to take control of the internet, they're going to be able to knock down any part, any website, any area of the world's internet. I mean, it's really that serious. And I don't understand why nobody is even caring two rats' asses. I mean, they still think that pornographic material is going to still be widely abundant, even if it's under a United Nations control. I beg to differ with them, because I just got to show you that the United Nations and the bureaucratic institutionalist, the international bureaucratic institutionalist, have some kind of favorable understanding with Islam. And Islam ain't going to have pornographic material if they are, I guess, the legitimate group of people that, I guess, the United Nations and the international bureaucratic institutionalists are protecting. So I'm serious, man. I mean, you know, you're right about being lied to. It's about time people knew the truth. The unfortunate part about it is, Jimmy, is that people like you, people like myself, people that want to be informed, people that want to be enlightened, they aren't as abundant as the mindless, entertainment-filled, star-fetish pieces of immature garbage that seem to flood the world and turn perfectly good food into crap nowadays. So, you know, I even with that, I still try to keep a optimistic mind, but it's hard. You know what I'm saying, Jimmy?
Yeah, I agree completely, man. Governments and bureaucratic companies and organizations, all that. So, you know, they've lied to people for years, and thanks to the internet and the explosion of free speech and free media outlets such as Breitbart and InfoWars and True Capitalist Radio Broadcast, people have opened their eyes, and that's why you now have Obama, you know, trying to sign away internet freedom. And yeah, I remember, what was it, SOPA and PIPA a few years ago and all that crap. And all this, you know, just trying to censor people's free speech. But you actually alluded to there that the, you know, the UN and all that have the have a favorable outlook on Islam. And I believe the reason that being is because the ideology of Islam enslaves everyone that isn't a man, in a sense. You know, their women are subjected to horrible conditions. Homosexuals are subjected to horrible conditions. But these people, you know, try to come out that, you know, Muslims are so oppressed and all that. It's not. It's the same people that social justice warriors believe are oppressed by white men, but they defend Muslims. It's pretty crazy what's going on in the world, man. And like I said,
it really is crazy, Jimmy. And let me tell you, I hope that, you know, cooler heads prevail, but it doesn't look like it. So that's why I'm trying to tell everybody to live it up and become a capitalist and understand how to capitalize, understand how to appreciate your existence, how to make your existence a pleasant one, a content one, a pursuit of happiness one. And that's all you can do as far as an individual. I mean, you can't necessarily change the world, but if you can appease yourself and help change one person at a time, how, in whatever means or capacity you can, I think that's really what life's about, man. Hey, do you want to give a shout-out to anybody there, Jimmy?
A Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty, and there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time.
Yeah, I don't mind, man. Thank you. Firstly, I'd like to thank yourself for doing yet another broadcast. But I'd like to give a shout-out to Sergeant Yoda, to regular TCA, Raiden Snake, and all the other members of the Inner Circle. So thanks, Ghost, for having me up here, man, and enjoy the rest of the broadcast, mate.
Hey, no, thank you, Jimmy. I appreciate the insight. I appreciate the commentary, and you're always welcome anytime, Jimmy. I appreciate it. And what's going on to Sergeant Yoda, regular TCA, and the Inner Circle? What's going on? Anyway, folks, it's about that time, I guess, for everybody's, well, one of the favorite part of the broadcast, I guess. That's Twitter shout-outs. All right? So for you folks that want a Twitter shout-out right now, go ahead and retweet the first tweet on my Twitter account at Politics Ghost. All one word, no underscores, Politics Ghost. All right? And the tweet to retweet is True Capitalist Radio Live. Do you understand that? True Capitalist Radio Live. If you retweet that broadcast, or you retweet that tweet, I will give you a Twitter shout-out live right here on the broadcast right now. Do we got any Twitter shout-outs there, engineer? All right. Well, let's go ahead and get to some Twitter shout-outs right now. We got Alt Game Freak. What's going on, man? Good to see you. We got somebody named a Horny Unicorn. Jesus Christ. Second name in. We got some freak show garbage. We got the Green Bio. How you doing, man? We got NG Costume for Toggle. What the hell does that mean? Sharknado versus Ghost. Oh, my God. I mean, give me a break. Are you equating me with that ridiculous movie, man? Sharknado versus Ghost. What a bunch of garbage, man. Anybody who watches that, I mean, you got more time on your hands than you got some problems. That's all I'm saying, all right? You got some freaking problems, man. We got the Brody Network in the house. We got the Swabian Capitalist. What's going on? We got the Green Leader. What's going on to the TCR Steam Chat in the house? We fought a shark. What's up with a shark crap? What's up with this shark garbage? Oh, here we go again. Here, look at this. A trans toilet. I'm looking at a toilet with a pair of balls on it, man. Good God. You idiots are sick. We've got Steven Ghostiverse. What the hell does that mean? Clinton 1, Alex 0. No, man, don't even go there. Seriously, man. All right? Seriously, don't even go there. Look, me and Alex Jones, we got personal issues, but don't even go there, seriously. Anyway, we got Ann and the Wizard, for Christ's sake. What's going on, Ann and the Wizard? Who else do we got going on here, Engineer? We got more Twitter shout-outs or what, Engineer? We got Hate Speech is Magic in the house. Strictly Diesel in the place. What's going on? Johnny Deck in the place. The Chefist. What's going on to the Chefist? How you doing, man? Who else do we got going on over here? Let's just continue going. Once again, retweet the first tweet on my Twitter account. The tweet to retweet is True Capitalist Radio Live, baby. Sergeant Yoda, the Norwegian capitalist in the house. What's going on, man? Oh, Jesus Christ. Trans toilet paper? Now we have a toilet paper with a freaking pair of balls on it. Good God. Oh, good Lord. Oh, Alex first, Ghost next. F you, all right? F you. We got Trump and Capitalist in the house. How you doing, Trump and Capitalist? Good to see you, man. Ghost a pilot. Don't even go there with that crap, you son of a bitch, all right? Don't compare me to that fruit bowl gay bastard, all right? Jesus Christ. Lion Guardians for Ghost, whatever that means. We've got... they call me TXT. What's going on, man? We've got Jay in the house. What's going on, Jay? Feral Capitalist in the place. What's going on, man? Who else do we got here? We got Generic CPU. Yeah, like a 386SX, man. I'm telling you. Good Lord. Who else? We're gonna take a couple more here. What's going on, Loose? The Loose Moose. What's going on to the Loose Moose? Who else do we got? All right, we're continuing going here. Regular TCA in the place. What's going on? Manhood Magic in the house. No golden ticket for Ghost. What the hell does that mean, you son of a bitch? What the hell does that mean? No peeners for Wiener. Oh, yeah, no kidding. All right, give me a break with that son of a bitch. All right. Hey, have you seen Humma lately? Oh, she has no ring no more. And now she's by Hillary Rotten Clinton's side saying, yes, I dive on this 70-year-old muff piss bag. Jesus Christ. Who else do we got going on here? We got DJ Reagan in the mix. We got the Metroid Junkie in the house. We got Can Capitalist. How you doing, man, Can Capitalist? We got Artron Havoc in the place. Who else do we got going on here? Once again, we're doing Twitter shout-outs live right here on the broadcast like we always do. All right, who else we got here? We got Ghostler's SS Circle. Shove it up your ass, all right? Ghostler's SS Circle. Those are my friends, all right? All right, those are my friends, for Christ's sake, man. And And, you know, to be honest with you folks, I've gotten some real heartfelt, sentimental emails from folks that have joined the inner circle that just, you know, it inspires me to continue going regardless what happens. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's the whole reason why I do this broadcast. The stories that I've heard, the majority of the people that are a part of the inner circle are comprised of individuals that have listened to this broadcast for a long time and came in as trolls and a bunch of troublemakers and that are now, believe it or not, beyond productive members of society. We've got really legitimate members of society. I mean, we got people from that are hard workers to millionaires. I'm not joking. We got a millionaire in the house. We got transgenders. We got a few transgenders in the ghost circle, for Christ's sake. Now, why would that be? Because I'll tell you why, folks. Because I understand the strife of the transgender and how it's being exploited by lesbian and gays. All right? I'm telling you, we got them all, baby. You know, we got a ghost inner circle member from Dubai, baby. Dubai. I'd love to go to Dubai, but I think they'd never let me leave, and they'd probably put me in jail or something, but you know what I mean? Anyway, folks, I mean, by the way, how many slots do we have left anyway, engineer? 7 left? Oh, my God, there's only 7 left. Although there are a few more left, folks, in the process of giving out refunds, I noticed that even though I give out a refund to folks, it doesn't add the count back on to the product itself. So even if we sell out these 7, I think that there's about 4 or 5 more left available because of the fact that I refunded folks' money and it didn't put back onto the count of slots available. So, and no, I'm not going to raise the price because I just think that's wrong, man. All right, I didn't do this for the money anyway, so I'm not going to raise the price on that. All right, so once they're gone, they're gone. I'm not doing that to folks, man. Anyway, who else do we got going on here? Fake friendship, $45. Like, shove it up your ass, asshole. You're just pissed that your goddamn stupid loser that isn't going to amount to garbage except sitting there flapping your fat Cheeto-stained fingers on a keyboard as a damn fat, freckle-faced, red-headed, beaten stepchild troll. You son of a bitch. These are my friends. These are my friends. Anyway, folks, who the hell else do we got going on over here, for Christ's sake? Anyway, we got Everlasting Heartstopper, whatever the hell that means. Crazy in the Coconut. What the hell does that mean, asshole? Jesus Christ. Golden Ticket to Hell. Shut up, you asshole, all right? Shove it up your ass. Goliad Barbecue Pit, 1836. You son of a... Shut up your ass! Don't make fun of Texas martyrs! How dare you! Don't you dare talk about the Texas martyrs, boy! Don't you dare! Don't you dare talk about the Texas martyrs! Son of a bitch! Trying to talk about the damn Texas martyrs, boy. We were the toughest sons of bitches on the goddamn this part of the planet, baby. Give me the mic. Hey, the Texas martyrs were the toughest sons of bitches on this side of the planet, baby, and we still are. Why do you think the damn federal government fears Texas, boy? Why do you think Obama fears Texas? You're goddamn right, boy. You all can go to hell. But I'm going to Texas. Davy Crockett, baby. Davy Crockett, fighting for liberty. You understand that, boy? Son of a bitch. Anyway, we are now in the second hour of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And, of course, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, folks, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. Jesus Christ, if you haven't already done so, please spread it around like wildfire and let everybody know that True Capitalist Radio is in effect and in the house, and we are live every Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. The official website, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. That's blogtalkradio.com/ghost. Anyway, let me get to a couple of more Twitter shout-outs, and I'm getting the hell off this stupid topic, for Christ's sake. People are trying to ruin my Taco Tuesday like a bunch of troll terrorists, cyber vermin assholes. So let's go ahead and continue on. We got Xara Hawks in the house. What's going on? We got the trans can. There we go, a freaking can with a pair of balls on it. Czech capitalist in the house. Princess Argenta. We've got the Brazilian spray, whatever the hell that means. Trans Texan martyr. Shove it up your ass, you piece of crap. All right? Shove it up your ass. Just shove it up your ass. We got Karaskin in the house. What's going on to Karaskin, baby? And what's going on to the second path of pain? Good to hear from you. How you doing? Ghostler Youth Circle. You son of a bitch. God damn it. All right. All right, that's it. I've already told you idiots, don't call me Ghostler. All right? Don't call me Ghostler, assholes. That's not funny. That's not amusing. All right? Don't call me Ghostler. All right. I've had enough, for Christ. I've had enough, and it's garbage. Give me the mic. Jesus Christ. What's going on to Charm Tooth? All right? Jesus Christ. I'm tired of this. I'm serious, man. You know what I mean? I'm sitting over here. I'm trying to, you know, get some interaction to the fans out here, and this is the kind of garbage I get, boy. This is the kind of garbage I get. What's going on at Jiggly Ribs? You know what I mean? Jesus Christ. We got Weston Capitalist in the house. Zim Tire. Jesus Christ. What's going on at Snow White in the house? Oh, good God, man. Blasphemous bastard in the place. Jesus, man. Look, that's enough. We can never have nice things. You know what I mean? That's why we can never have nice things. You understand that? Jesus Christ, man. Anyway, folks, we're going to move on to the broadcast. We're going to talk about whatever the hell you want to talk about. All right? Talk about whatever you want to talk about. All right, we're going to go ahead and take some calls here. 425-390-6146 is the number to call. As a matter of fact, let me call that one little bastard that was that called up earlier. Let's call that little bastard back. Call him back, engineer. What the hell are you doing, you little bastard?
The person you have called.
Oh, did he do one of those ones where I'm going to block him? Jesus Christ. Anyway, let's get back to some callers on this Taco Tuesday, baby, all right? This is a Taco Tuesday free format edition. I want to see what people have to say out here, so let's go ahead and get to some callers here. How about 818? You're on the horn on this Taco Tuesday.
Hey, Ghost, seeing as how it's Taco Tuesday, you think me and Homeland Security can double dim in your wife's pink taco today?
I mean, that was already used like 2 or 3 weeks ago, man. I mean, is that supposed to win you some laughs? Look, well, I'll pretend we didn't hear it. We'll go ahead and give you one more opportunity to say something funny, and if you don't, I'm going to air out your number. Go ahead. Go ahead. I'm giving you an opportunity. Right. Say something funny, man.
All right. What's the similarity between a Make-A-Wish Foundation kid and good jokes? They never get old.
Oh, my God. This is a major fail for Christ. Do you have both your parents in your household?
No, they're dead.
No, seriously. All right, I obviously one of them's missing. Which one's still around? Seriously.
No, seriously, they're both dead. I'm adopted.
Oh, you're adopted? Oh, Jesus Christ! I mean, and you know, I'm starting to second guess adoptees here. You know, and I mean, look, I always felt bad for, like, you know, these orphans. I always felt bad for them. I don't want to get into it, but I actually do work every now and then during holidays. You know, going out there, you know, feeding these kids, so on and so forth. But now you got this Colin Kaepernick situation, which was an unappreciative, adopted piece of garbage. And then you've got this over here. Hey, let me talk to you for a little bit there, adopted kid. What exactly is your mental outlook on life? And what is it that pains you, that prohibits you from acting like a regular, upstanding human being and being able to talk for yourself? I mean, do you have an innate fear that is deep-seated within you that prohibits you from actually articulating your feelings? Go ahead.
Hello?
We're waiting for you, man.
Hello?
Yeah, of course. Shut up. Get this idiot off. Get out of here, for Christ's sake. Yeah. You want to know why he's going, hello? I'm going to pretend I didn't hear that. Hello? You want to know why? Because I struck a nerve with this moron. And anytime you strike a nerve with the truth with people and they don't want to hear it, that's what you're going to get. You're going to get like they pretended they didn't hear you. You're going to get periphery, blinders. That's what you're going to get with these people. All right? I mean, I call this kid's mental capacity out. All right? He's got a void. All right? I don't know what it is with these adopted kids. I mean, you would think that they'd be appreciative that somebody that wasn't even their seed, for Christ's sake, would want to take care of them, make sure that they're fed, make sure that they're protected, make sure, no. They're still got this deep-seated, oh, I was adopted, and the world needs to help me. You stupid son of a, this Colin Kaepernick, unappreciative prick mentality. Seriously. You know what I'm saying? I hate that I'm even saying this. I'm serious. I hate that I'm even saying this, but I think I might have to second-guess adopted kids now. You know what I mean? I'm going to have to look at them a little bit different and basically remember in the back of my mind that these people got some deep-seated issues, for Christ's sake, man. Really deep-seated issues. I mean, look at Colin Kaepernick, man. This idiot is trying to take a freaking – well, he's not really standing. He was sitting – during the national anthem, but he was trying to draw attention to black strife. This son of a bitch was brought up in white suburbia with a white family who adopted him and gave him a great life. I mean, do you understand that? I mean, Jesus Christ, you unappreciative adopted prick! You know who was an adoptee, folks, that didn't use that against him? He didn't draw on the fact that he had a bad upbringing and that he was in a damn in an orphanage or anything of that nature. The man who founded Wendy's, Dave Thomas. That's right, folks. He was adopted, all right? He was goddamn adopted. He was adopted as a teenager. He was adopted as like a late when he was 12. And did he use that against him? Did he was like, oh, I'm Dave Thomas. Oh, nobody loves me. And no, he didn't. You know what he did? He said, look, I have the raw end of the stick in my life, and I want to live a little lavish. All right? Now, how am I going to live lavish? Well, the adopted family that Dave Thomas was adopted by owned a small diner. And in that small diner, Dave Thomas learned every aspect of the food industry, and in that, he didn't initially create Wendy's. As a matter of fact, he actually helped Colonel Sanders create KFC first, believe it or not. I mean, I know the whole history of these franchises. That's why you got to know history, folks. That's why you got to know these things, all right? He actually helped Colonel Sanders create KFC, and then once, you know, he got his money from the KFC deal, he created Wendy's, and the rest is history. The guy was a freaking billionaire, for Christ's sake. All right? But no, you've got idiots like that just called me up acting like a complete jag-off. You know, oh, I'm adopted. Oh, is that what you do? You go around feeling sorry for yourself all day, for Christ's sake? I mean, give me a break. Oh, my God. Anyway, look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get off keister there. I'm just tired of the garbage, man, that is being produced in America. All right, man, now if it isn't single dirty dish rag whore mothers that are raising these weak men, now what, it's adopted people now that have a problem? Thanks, Kaepernick, you stupid, sorry sack of two-bit quarterback son of a bitch. Jesus Christ. Did you hear Marvin Harrison? He was a commentator, former NFL football player. He came out and basically said that this brother ain't black. I'm glad somebody said it. I'm glad somebody said it. I was talking about this on Sunday, all right? I was talking about this on Sunday that I wanted a black check on Colin Kaepernick. All right? I want a black check on Colin Kaepernick. At first, I thought, hey, you know, maybe Colin Kaepernick is a Puerto Rican. You know what I mean? I mean, he kind of looks a little Puerto Rican. But now, all right, now I'm starting to realize, now that he wants to convert to Islam because of his damn girlfriend, pure cuckery, by the way, goddamn Kaepernick, pure cuckery, all right, he also is going to have a traditional Muslim wedding, for Christ's sake, all right? Now I'm starting to see a little bit of camel jockey coming out, with all due respect, in Colin Kaepernick. You know what I'm saying? I mean, hey, Kaepernick, are you going to stop yourself from playing football and face Mecca and... Kaepernick, you son of a bitch. I mean, this was an adopted kid. This was an adopted kid that was brought up in a white family, man. They gave him everything. How do you think he was able to be an NFL football player? I mean, he was given the silver spoon, man. I mean, everybody in his community thought he was great. His family was proud of him, the whole nine yards, and this son of a bitch goes and pulls this. What an ignorant piece of trash. I'm serious. Hey, you saw that Twitter tweet that I tweeted sometime this morning. Hey, Colin Kaepernick, hey, put your money where your mouth is, boy. Why don't you stop getting paid in protest for what you supposedly believe in? Then maybe not only will I, but everybody who's actually afflicted with this strife will actually believe your white privileged ass. Jesus Christ. Give me my drink. Give me my drink, for Christ's sake. Ugh. I'm telling you, I hope that every time Colin Kaepernick sits down for the national anthem, they throw pieces of ham at that son of a bitch. All right? How about a ham sandwich, Kaepernick? How about a ham sandwich? You stupid, dumb, treasonous son of a bitch. Jesus Christ. And I was just recently told here on Twitter that Colin Kaepernick also has a cross tattoo on him with a Bible quote. I mean, you see how ignorant this idiot is, for Christ's sake? Idiot! Complete ignorance! And that's what people like D-Ray take advantage of, this dumbass mental capacity, this ill-informed ignorance. That's what Obama takes advantage of. That's what Sean King takes advantage of. That's what Rachel Dolezal takes advantage of. Ignorant, ill-informed, uneducated pricks like this. Oh, my God. Jesus Christ, Kaepernick. You know what? I'm challenging you, Kaepernick. Why don't you come on my show? It's just a freaking phone call, asshole. Come on my show and defend your stance and prove to the world that you are an articulate individual that understands exactly your stances on whatever strife that you claim you're standing up for, you sorry sack of crap. I'm calling you out, Kaepernick. You're a sucky-ass quarterback. You know, you did one good season, you dumbass, and the only reason is because you had one play that none of these defensive coaches were able to create a defensive scheme around, all right? All right, and then you choked, you know, in the championship game, and then you got your $100 million contract, and you've sucked the chrome up of a 57 Chevy bumper ever since. And now that you're riding the bench because you're a two-bit piece of trash, I personally believe that you are utilizing this as an opportunity to point a spotlight at your stupid, imbecilic, no-skill-having ass, Kaepernick. And look, I'm sorry I'm going off on Kaepernick here, folks, but give me a break, all right? Give me a damn break. Anyway, let's take another caller here. We got the Teutonic Plague. What's going on this Taco Tuesday, man?
Ghost, happy Taco Tuesday. Love the show. I got two things I want to say.
All right, go ahead, man.
First, I have done something for the Capitalist Army and the show. I'm repping on the Capitalist Army. I created a T-shirt. Did you actually get to see that, sir?
No, actually, I did not.
I will tweet it to you right now, and while I'm tweeting it to you, hey, I genuinely want to join the Inner Circle. I really do. But there are only a few spots left, but I will have money, enough money in the bank to do this on Friday at the earliest, Monday at the latest. I've heard people asking you, hey, save me a spot, and you said you'd save spots for the fans, and I genuinely want to do this. So do you think you could find
First of all, I'm not saving spots per se, but there are spots available now that aren't on the official count because I gave refunds to folks. And, you know, I'm not going to put those up for sale again until, you know, people that really wanted to be a part of this want to. So, I mean, I'm not necessarily saving the spot. There's only five left as we speak, but I'm pretty sure that those ones that aren't on the count, because I know there's at least five, maybe six or seven on that I've given refunds to that are not in this count. So, yeah, no problem, man. I'll go ahead and do that for you, Teutonic. I know you're a pretty good fan, and you're always listening, and you're a capitalist. So, yeah, I'll go ahead and do that. And, no, I have not seen the shirt, man. I have not seen it.
Well, hold on. Let me tweet it to you right now. All right,
let me go ahead and check. Yeah. All right, let me go ahead and check this out. Now, what is it? Hold on, let me see this. Put it up, engineer, you sack of crap. Sorry, Jesus Christ.
It's fine.
All right.
A Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty. And there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time.
Well, hold on. I'll tell you what. I gotta continue doing the show here. I'll go ahead and take a look at it after the show. What is it that you want? What do you want to do with that? You want to give it away? You want to sell it? What is it you want to do?
Well, I plan to buy one for myself, I'd like to sell it, but that would involve me spending money buying the shirts. What do you advise if I want to sell it? What do you advise that I do?
Well, I'll tell you this. Look, I'm not going to tell anybody how to do business because if that's the case, I mean, then I should do it. But I don't want to do it. I'm trying to allow the fan base to be creative. I know we got a lot of creative fans out here. I mean, look, I have no problem with you folks, you know, creating your own shirts, all right? I have no problem with you guys creating your own merch, for Christ's sake, all right? I mean, look, this is why the only time I've ever really, you know, I really don't care what y'all do, all right? Now, don't get me wrong, if y'all make $1 million off of shirts relating to this show, you know, we're going to have to make a deal and, nothing personal, just business. But if you're just making enough to get your ass through some college, and if you're just making yourself sustain yourself and to become a goddamn independent person, I don't really give two rat's asses about that. But once again, if you by some chance, create $1 million shirt or something, believe me, we're going to have to make a deal, all right? So I'm not going to tell you how to do that, Teutonic. I mean, Google, how to do that. There's a lot of on-demand, print situations that you could possibly look to. But that's to the extent I'm going to give there. All right. Anyway, let's move on. We got about 5-10 minutes left. Let's take some more callers here on this free format Taco Tuesday. All right. How about 425? You're on the horn. What's up on this Taco Tuesday?
You calling me?
Yeah, it's you, man.
Oh, really? Well, I wanted to ask you why you go so easy on Trump. You never really mentioned any of his problems, like how he tried to sue Bill Maher over a joke about him being like an orangutan or something. What do you have to say about that?
I think that, hey, you can do whatever the hell you want to do as far as I'm concerned. I mean, that's a light comparison into what Hillary Rotten Clinton is doing, forcing Google to suppress searches for her Clinton body count, Clinton health records, so on and so forth. I mean, did you see CNN literally censor a tweet from Donald Trump taking out the word crooked out of crooked Hillary, for Christ's sake? All right, and to be honest with you, I think Bill Maher should be sued, man. Bill Maher's a piece of trash. Did you see him and Michael Moore? Michael Moore, I tweeted a tweet in which I don't know how Bill Maher was able to get on the tarmac of the same, I guess, airplane hangar, airplane tarmac where Donald Trump's plane was, but Bill Maher got close enough to where he could touch his plane. I mean, literally, what Michael Moore and Bill Maher were doing was showing terrorists how easy it was to get close to their plane. And in my personal opinion, I think that the FBI should investigate Bill Maher and Michael Moore because that's very dangerous. This is a presidential nominee under the watch of the Secret Service. I strongly believe that Bill Maher should have Secret Service, FBI, asking him a few questions. Why exactly did you want to prove that you could get close to Donald Trump's airplane? I mean, this is inducing terrorism as far as I'm concerned, and you could tell Bill Maher I said that. I mean, let me tell you something right now. You want to talk about a soulless piece of backpedaling, double-talking piece of garbage. Take a look at what Bill Maher used to say back in the old days. You know, as a matter of fact, you should watch Bill Maher's Victory Begins at Home, that stand-up routine. And look, I got to be honest with you, I actually like that that routine. It, a lot of anti-feminist, rhetoric coming out of there, a lot of pro-woman garbage. Now he is completely silent on that. Why? Because the liberal, the Democrat, political side over there has embraced feminism, has embraced wild Yehudiism. As a matter of fact, in Victory Begins at Home, Bill Maher even takes a hardcore racial shot at wild Yehudis. And where is he on that stance now? Nowhere to be found. All right? He is a double-talking piece of soulless trash whore crap. And anybody who watches Bill Maher for any kind of legitimacy is completely ignorant, all right? Completely goddamn ignorant. Anyway, folks, all right, I mean, give me a freaking break. Why am I going light on Trump? Are you kidding me? Donald Trump is our last stance for America, you moron. He's our last stance. I've said it, and I'll say it again. If you are not voting for Donald Trump, then you are anti-American. If you are voting for Hillary Rotten Clinton, then you are anti-American. You understand that? If you're voting for Hillary Clinton, you're spitting in our troops' face. That's what you're doing. You're spitting on our troops, all the troops that died for this country, you son of a bitch. I'm serious. If you do not vote for Donald Trump, you're an anti-American piece of garbage. And as far as I'm concerned, when Donald Trump starts deporting the illegal immigrant criminals, you should go with him. You people that hate America should go with him. You disgusting, filthy, leftist, liberal trash. You should be deported to some third world nation and see how you like it then, huh? You know, I hate to get racial here, but, you know, I hear these black folks on Black Lives Matter side, the Black Panther side, the black extremist side. We were taken from Africa, baby. We was taken from Africa for my kids, baby. I want to go back to Africa, baby. You know, that was actually tried before, you morons. You know that? Monroe, President Monroe, the man who, of course, wrote the Manifest Destiny Monroe Doctrine, he was the actual first president to pardon a whole bunch of slaves once the industrialists took control of the North and they allowed slavery to be abolished in the industrial North, all right? Now, what Monroe did is he allowed those slaves to go back to Africa because that's what they wanted. I mean, remember, I mean, I want to go back to the homeland, I want to go this. So what Monroe did was he allowed a humongous group of slaves that were on the plantation, at least two generations in of slaves, sent them back to Africa. Now, where did he send them? He sent them to what is now known as Liberia, which, of course, the capital of Liberia is Monrovia. Monrovia, yeah, to honor Monroe. Now, what did the slaves do when they went to Africa? Did they take any kind of skill, any kind of knowledge, any kind of appreciation to make Liberia a better place? No! You know what they did? They enslaved the natives of goddamn Liberia. Yeah, black slaves from America who went back to Africa, slaved native Liberians. That's a fact, and that's what that whole tribalism garbage right now in Liberia is all about. So how come D-Ray and all this other garbage, these Black Panthers and all this crap, how come they don't talk about that? How come they don't talk about that? I'm serious. That's why Liberia is still at war, folks. I mean, these are two different tribes, all right? These are the natives and those that were the transplants from America to Liberia, courtesy of Monroe. And you see, folks, what are you going to say about that? I mean, and, you know, there is an actual great documentary. I don't really like to plug Vice very much, but during the beginning of Vice, they actually put out some pretty good documentaries. There was a documentary about Liberia that I'm going to try to tweet after this broadcast that is shockingly riveting. That gives you an insight on what true poverty is. As a matter of fact, I should tweet at Colin Kaepernick this damn video because it is the most grotesque form of freaking poverty that I have ever witnessed in my goddamn life. So that's all I'm saying, folks. Okay? That's all I'm saying, black folks. I mean, let's talk about some black history. I'm telling you, I know more about black history than most black folks, all right? And why? Because you've got to know it so that when they're out here mouthing off like they know something, you can prove that you know more than they ask. Jesus Christ. Anyway, folks, let's just go ahead and get to everybody's favorite part of the broadcast, all right? And I'm talking about Radio Graffiti. That's right, folks. Radio Graffiti, the part of the broadcast where the spectators become a part of the spectacle. All you've got to do is give me a call at area code 425-390-6146 And when I call on your area code, you've got exactly 3 to 4 seconds to say whatever it is that's on your mind. Do you understand that? That's why we call this Radio Graffiti. Anyway, folks, do we got any goddamn Radio Graffiti calls there, engineer? All right, well, let's go ahead and start Radio Graffiti right now. Woo! Who do we got going on here, boy? We've got Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Ghost?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to tell you, I did a cartoon of you and Tub Guy, and I'm going to be doing a series where you and him save Engineer from Hillary Clinton because she kidnapped Engineer, and as well as Donald Trump, and you're going to be both fucking Leslie Jones.
All right, yeah, that's great. All right, I mean, couldn't you make a cartoon that's a little bit more political and that could help progress, maybe young people interpret the seriousness of life through the variations of cartooning? But no, you want to make cartooning having something to do with sexual activity. You see how sick and sadistic our goddamn country is? And I guarantee you that is a single mother larva. Single mother larva, man. I mean, why don't you make a – if you're that good, make a cartoon to help somebody, man. Jesus Christ. 831 Radio Graffiti.
I love it when they call me Big Kloppa. Stick your hands in the air if you will fuck mayors. I love it when they call me
– shut up, man. You see, that is – you know, every time I try to, you know, give these bronies the benefit of the doubt, this garbage starts coming back around. You know, the fact that these people Jesus Christ. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Benito Ghostini Radio Graffiti.
I'm Uncle Ghost. And that's right. Come on over here. Give me your
$45.
All right, come on over here. Sit on Uncle
Ghost.
Slap. Keep contributing to the
Ghost Circle.
Keep contributing. That's right. Now come on. Yeah, shut up, you idiot. Shut your stupid mouth. All right? Give me a damn break. Who else do we have going on over here? How about Anonymous Radio Graffiti? Radio Graffiti.
Lego Fan 421. Radio Graffiti.
Look at this photograph. Every time I do it makes me laugh. I get so red. And what the hell is on to eat? This is where I grew up.
I mean, enough. Good. This is driving me insane. This crap is driving me insane. Enough of this garbage. Look, I need a drink. Give me my drink, for Christ's sake. Ugh. I mean, mean, this is enough. I've had enough of Nickelback. Enough of this garbage, man. I've had enough of this crap. Jesus Christ. 210, Radio Graffiti.
Quick, I got 32 jobs over the course of a week. I think it's interesting. I got 32 jobs, and most niggas say they can't find one. Niggas.
Man, come on with the racist garbage, all right? Now you're going to have everybody thinking that I'm racist when I am a melting pot of friendship, for Christ's sake, man. A melting pot of friendship. I mean, don't make me have to call one of my blacks. I've already done that once. Don't make me do that one more again, all right? I happen to have a whole bunch of friends that happen to be black, all right? I happen to have a whole bunch of friends that happen to be Hispandex, too. So, I mean, give me a damn break, man. How about Anonymous Radio Graffiti?
Willy Wonka, Willy Wonka is dead. Willy Wonka, Willy Wonka is dead. Willy Wonka, you're a fruity ass, bro. I'm sad. You're a fruit mold. Willy Wonka, epic fail, bro.
Woo! I mean, Jesus Christ, man. Look, yesterday Gene Wilder dies. This son of a bitch, his body hasn't even, started rigor mortis. And you sons of bitches are making trolls about this poor bastard, man. Oh, I feel bad for the guy, man. Are you kidding me? A life's work of being an entertainer, a comedian, an actor. Oh, my God. And this is the thanks. This is the thanks that you get, you know? Willy Wonka is dead, you assholes, and you people could care less. Good God. Jesus Christ. 978 Radio Graffiti.
Hell, I mean, in my personal opinion,
Leslie Jones
is a good piece of ass.
Oh, my God. Enough. Look, you idiots were tweeting that stupid Leslie Jones nude at me like all day yesterday. I don't want to see that crap. I mean, once you see that nude, it just... Oh, good God, I don't want to see it. Oh, my God. Then she sticks her tongue out. Jesus Christ, man. 719, Radio Graffiti. Yeah, let me tell you something. I'm the talent boy. You understand that? Oh, what the hell are you trying to do? You're trying to splice me like some fat Snorlax? I mean, is that what you're trying to do? You're trying to, splice me like some fat, disgusting Snorlax? Wow, 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 wow. Jesus Christ, I'm telling you, man. I don't even know why I do this. I'm telling you, goddamn sons of bitches, man. I'm telling you that right now. Anonymous, Radio Graffiti.
This is Sparta, Radio Graffiti.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide. No escape from reality. Open your eyes. Look up to the skies and
All right. Well, at least it wasn't that stupid. Look at that photograph. I'm a little bit fruity, yes. I come from Canada, and I don't know what I'm saying. I'm a stupid fruit bowl, and I'm crying like a stupid hoe. I mean, give me a goddamn break. Who else do we got here, for Christ's sake? Good God.
Jesus Christ. How about nine? Oh, no, wait a minute. You're not even in queue, for Christ's sake. How about, Jesus Christ, with these sons of bitches. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Yo, Ghost, what's good? What's good? What's good, my dude?
What's going on?
Oh, I have a. You hear about Bantu? You know, the gorilla that like died or whatever.
The gorilla? You're talking about Harambe?
No, Bantu. You know, the gorilla that got sedated or whatever and like died after.
Now, I don't know what the hell you're talking about. What difference does it make? All right, not to quote Hillary Clinton, but goddamn, it's Radio Graffiti over here. Was that your sister or something? Jesus Christ, 586 Radio Graffiti.
This me?
Yeah, it's you.
Huh? Hey, I'm not sure if this is relevant to anything, but I was driving yesterday and I saw some sort of green military vehicle just going down the road like it was normal. It looked like a Striker by Google Images. I don't know if that's symbolic of anything, but that was certainly something I saw that was really awkward.
You're not the only one reporting that, sir. We're seeing UN vehicles all across the country. We're seeing armored vehicles. We're seeing new kind of armored vehicles that are traveling highways that have never been seen before. I think things are being mobilized. I think people need to keep their eyes peeled. They need to realize that what I've been saying, what Drudge has been saying, what Breitbart's saying, what Alex Jones has been saying, it's finally starting to come to fruition, and they better start getting prepared, to say the least, all right? They better start getting prepared. 504, Radio Graffiti. What the hell? I mean, is that your... hopefully that's your single or something, because the song sucks if you're trying to promote it for another artist. How about 206 Radio Graffiti?
Nickelback sucks.
Yeah, no kidding. It sucks. I don't know what the hell these people are doing. I don't know if this is the new Rick Roll or whatever, but it needs to stop. And it needs to stop now! Anonymous Radio Graffiti. Jesus Christ. Turn down your radio, Jagoff. Jesus Christ. Anonymous Radio Graffiti. I mean, what do we got, a bunch of Helen Keller deaf mutes? Clear out these lines then, engineer. And we got a bunch of Helen Keller deaf mutes. Get them out of here. Get them all out. Just clear them out. Clear them all out. Sick of these freaks, man. Just clogging up the line, not saying a goddamn thing. Get them out! Who else have we got here? 574 Radio Graffiti.
He's boring, aren't he? Donald Trump. He's boring. He's stupid, too, man. He's dumb. I mean, that's why I'm not going to vote for Donald Trump. I'm going to vote for Hillary Clinton.
Shut up. That's a stupid splice, first of all. I never said that. Shut your face. Shut your stupid, stinking, fat, salmon-smelling face. How about 708, Radio Graffiti?
Hey, Ghost, it's G. What's up?
Hey, what's going on? It's G. How you doing, G?
I'm doing good. I saw some douchebag on Twitter who called himself No Pussy for G and showed a cat picture. It wasn't even my cat. So that was it was bad troll and just really mean at the same time.
Oh, man, that's horrible. Come on, man. Why are y'all messing with G, for Christ's sake? He just lost his cat. He just lost his damn cat. Come on, and my condolences, G, and you know how these trolls are, man. They're sick, twisted idiots, to say the least, man. They got a few problems, man. How about 808, Radio Graffiti?
Hey, go, screw the capitalists here, man.
Hey, what's going on, Kahuna? How you doing, man?
Doing fine here. Just going through a freaking hurricane, but, you know, tied everything down and freaking house is hurricane-proof, so I'm fine.
Oh, man, so you got some kind of tropical storm hurricane-type, like, activity out there in Hawaii?
Yeah, two of them, in fact. One's actually supposed to be hitting anytime soon, and Not sure when the other one will hit.
Oh, yeah, man. No, look, I've been keeping up with the weather radar. I've been seeing a lot of weird cloud formations. I mean, it's just very, very weird if you look on the global radar. That's why I was even saying over there in the Baja region, the last time I checked was some really weird strands of, I don't know if it was tropical activity, but definitely in the green, yellow, and red zone. And you're telling us right now you're in the land of Hawaii. You're getting ready to be hit with a hurricane, man?
Yep, and I'll be honest with you. The freaking clouds, they look a little look strange to me, to say the least.
Oh, man. Hey, you want to give a shout-out there, Kahuna?
Yeah, sure. Shout-out for you guys, to Capitalist Army, as well as the Inner Circle, man, as well as Teutonic, Karaskin, and to G, man, and sorry about your cat.
Yeah, I hear you. And stay safe, Kahuna. Let me tell you something right now. That would be one of my biggest fears is to, you know, it is in the middle of the ocean. It's a small landmass, so I don't think that there'll be any kind of Cat 5, Cat 4, any kind of hurricane of that capacity. But still, what I don't like about being in Hawaii, man, is that, you know, if it's a big hurricane, Hawaii is solely dependent on imports to keep society going. You know what I'm saying? And, the supermarkets run dry as it relates to goods. When products leave the shelves, I mean, it can become a precarious situation, man, precarious situation. So, once again, stay safe, Kahuna, and thank you for calling. And hopefully everything goes well and it's just a lot of rain and nothing more. Anyway, we got, who else? We got 813, Radio Graffiti.
By your friends here. There's only 27 slots left in the Ghost Inner Circle. Ghost.market. Write in your goddamn browser. It's that simple. And all you assholes that say that I'm a shameless bastard, hey, it's the truth.
Now, shut up, all right? I'm tired of you people calling me a sellout, all right? If I was a sellout, I wouldn't have put 250 limit, all right? I would have just said, hey, it's open season. Let's get 2,000 people. Let's get 3,000 people. That would have been a stupid, sadistic, ridiculous sellout crap. These are my friends, all right? The Ghost Circle is my friends, for Christ's sake, man. Let me tell you something. Anybody in the circle who private messages me, I always get back to them, or I try to answer every goddamn message. Do you understand that, boy? And you people are just pissed because you can't get that close. You're just like, no, all I can do is troll because I'm stupid. I have no intellectual curiosity. I was raised by my dirty dish rag horse single mother, and I don't know how to articulate anything. I'm stupid. Of course you are. Of course you are, you son of a bitch. These are my friends, all right? These are my friends. You son of a bitch. Anyway, here, let me continue. Jesus Christ, man. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
Hey, Ghost, I was going to tell you. Before I start drawing the cartoon, I want to have a four-way with you, Tub.
Well, you know what? I don't really care. As a matter of fact, just by the sound of your voice, I think that you'd be doing the whole world a favor by drinking some bleach tonight, you sorry sack of crap. All right? Or sit in the damn closed garage and turn the car on and take deep breaths, you waste of human flesh. All right? Stupid moron.
I'm gonna do animation of you, Ghost, and I'm gonna do this, and it's gonna be sexual because I'm a stupid pervert, and I probably should be on some kind of like sexual list, like sexual predators list.
Stupid dumbass. All right. Seriously, I hope you get cancer of the prick, you stupid fruit bowl. I'm not kidding around. Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
This is Sparta, Radio Graffiti.
Say you're fucking sorry and stop acting like an idiot. Say you're sorry.
I'm sorry, Master. I'm sorry. I won't do it again. I swear, Master.
Say you're goddamn sorry, as you son of a bitch.
I said I'm sorry, Master. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Stop acting like like an Aspie tart. I'm not joking around, you fucking idiot. You fucking say sorry, or I'll take you a trip to the woodshed, boy.
No, Buster, no.
Man, you son of a bitch. Screw you, man. I'm tired of this crap, man. Stupid dumbass splicing, for Christ's sake. I'm telling you, shove it up your ass. Jesus, and shove it up your ass. Man, I'm glad we only got 5 minutes left of this son of a bitch. Give me the mic. Give me the mic. I'm serious. I'm glad we only got 5 minutes left in this goddamn son of a bitch. Jesus Christ, man. Because I'm telling you, I Jesus Christ, man. It pisses me off! 267 Radio Graffiti. Oh, great. We got a Helen Keller deaf mute. Either that or he's put the phone up a shit funnel. We got 909 Radio Graffiti. Unfortunately, we can't understand it because of your goddamn Obama phone. Jesus Christ. Anonymous Radio Graffiti. I mean, I just said that. I just freaking said that. God damn it. You damn freaking internet butt stalker ass trolls. Good God, I just freaking said that. I mean, this is sick, man. This is a sick mentality you people are having here. You understand it? This is a sick internet butt stalker mentality. A sick internet butt stalker mentality. You idiots, man. Give me the goddamn mic. You scumbags. You've ruined my Taco Tuesday like you always do. I bet you're patting yourselves on the back right now, aren't you? I bet you're all... You son of a bitch. I'm telling you, man, I deserve more I deserve more respect! I deserve more respect, you sacks of crap. You sack of crap. I wish this was your fate! You understand that, you sack of crap? I wish that was your face! I wish that was your fate! I wish it was your face! I'm taking one more call, and I'm getting the hell out of here. 614, Radio Goddamn Graffiti!
And now for an excerpt of Storytime with Top Badge. Oh, my.
I need to go. Well, we are in diapers, just go then. And without warning, Twilight pounces Rainbow with a tickle attack. Rainbow loses control and uses her diaper. After a bit of more, Rainbow was released from Twilight's tickling torture. Why did you do that, Twilight? I just wanted you not to worry, okay? So I thought we could have that kind of fun. Sorry, you're not the only one, okay? Twilight points to her diaper, showing that she too...
Are you reading Masked Pony's stories about Pampers? Are you actually doing it? I mean, not Masked Pony. Oh my
Give me the mic. Give me the goddamn mic. Good God. Oh, good God.
All right, look, I'm getting the hell out of here, folks. All right, follow me on Twitter. Politics Ghost is the name to follow. All one word, no underscores. Politics Ghost. And, of course, bookmark the official website of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. That's blogtalkradio.com/ghost. All right, you better be here tomorrow for a Wednesday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. You better be here, boy. You understand that? We are live every Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. Spread it around like wildfire. And let everybody know that True Capitalist Radio is in effect and in the house every Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. Come on, baby. Come on.
A Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty. And there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time. A Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty. And there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time.
Well, we are now in the third and post-show edition hour of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And, of course, I'm your host, the man they call Ghost, yada, yada, yada. Look, I'm serious, man. You people are pissing me off. You people have ruined my Taco Tuesday. You turned yesterday into a carpet-munching Monday. I'm getting sick of this crap, all right? I'm getting sick of this garbage. Oh, God. Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. All right. Let me calm down here, folks. All right. I'm going to go ahead and... I mean, I don't even know why I'm even doing a post-show third-hour edition, to be completely honest with you, after the garbage that I have been bombarded with today. All right? And it's been utter filth, it's been utter garbage, and it makes me sick, man. I mean, all the hours, man, we're approaching almost 1,300 hours of my life. Do you get that? 1,300 hours of my life. And this is the kind of respect that I get, for Christ's sake, all right? And then you're wondering why I've got Ghost Inner Circle going on. Let me tell you something. Those are my friends. Those are my friends, for Christ's sake, man. You should read the heartfelt emails, man, the inspiring emails that these individuals have all written to me. I mean, these people were much like you idiots. They're out here trolling. They're out here creating a digital ruckus, acting like trolls and cyber vermin. But by God, once I left, they went back to the archive and listened to every damn broadcast and realized that yours truly was saying the damn truth, and they got inspired to become capitalists, they got inspired to become self-productive individuals, and by God, each and every one of them people that are a part of the Ghost Inner Circle, each and every one of those folks, I'm telling you this right now, each and every one of those folks are an inspiration to me. And they're the whole reason why I do this broadcast, folks. All right?
This is the reason why I do this broadcast, because I'm trying to spark synapses in capitalists throughout the world. That's my objective of the show. That's the whole reason why I do this broadcast, folks. By God, I'm serious. If we had more capitalists, folks, this world would be a better place. If we had educated people who understood capitalism, who were self-sustaining, who wanted to carve out their own destiny and refuse to be dependent on some goddamn government, this world would be a better place. Mark my word, it would be a goddamn better place. And that's why I'm doing what I'm doing, folks. Giving free information for folks that actually want to absorb it, those that actually want to take advantage of it, those that want to apply it to their lives and make their lives that much better. That's why I do what I do, and I'm telling you, each and every one of these emails from the Ghost Inner Circle has a heartfelt sentiment that is just, I can't stop now. I cannot stop. All right? I cannot stop. So anyway, I mean, I hope that you individuals that are out there listening know that that's why I'm doing this. Do you understand that? I mean, I could be doing something else, probably making more money, I'll be completely honest with you. I could be doing anything else, all right? But the reason I'm doing this, folks, is because radio, the audio medium of radio, penetrates the psyche to the point in which you can make people better if they absorb the information into that cranium of theirs. And if they can absorb that information and apply that to their lives, then it makes them a better person. I mean, just ask the inner circle, baby. You understand that? I mean, to be honest with you, I kind of want to be like Dan Pena. For you folks that are unaware of Dan Pena, he's a billionaire. And he's an individual that helps people try to get their start in the success realm of business, all right? I mean, he has generated from his students, from people that listen to Dan Pena and his motivation and his teachings, his people, his inner circle, all right? And let me tell you, you know how much Dan Pena charges to attend his seminar that's a week long at his castle in Scotland? $25,000, okay? $25,000 Dan Pena charges so that he can motivate you into becoming a goddamn millionaire. $50 billion his people have generated. I mean, why do you think Dan Pena did it? And, you know, folks, he didn't start off charging $25,000. He used to do this for free. He used to, you know, rent hotel halls and give out the information that people are now paying $25,000 a pop to receive. Do you understand this? And that's why I'm doing this for free. That's why I'm giving away information. That's why I'm enlightening the public to those that want their synapses sparked and those that have an element of intellectual curiosity. That's why I do what I do. There's no other motive here. There's no other goddamn motive here, folks. And I'm telling you this right now. Whoever joins the inner circle, and let me see. How many slots are left, engineer? There's only 4 more slots left. I can tell you this right now. Those who are in the inner circle, it'll be the best investment and the best $45 that they've ever invested in their life. You know what I'm saying? I mean, in retrospect, they're going to be rather shocked on how this little $45 investment turned their lives into something full-fledged successful. Full-fledged successful, man. I'm not kidding around, all right? So give me a break. Anyway, let me go ahead and take some more callers here. For all you folks that are listening, I mean, this is the post-show edition.
The only way that you can listen to this broadcast right now in the third hour is if you are listening on the phone or if you're listening on a relayed stream somewhere across these internets. That's the only way that you're going to listen to the third hour. And look, here in about a week and a half, folks, the third hour will no longer be a exclusive private third hour, all right? We're going to have 3 hours of true capitalist radio, all right? I'm not joking, all right? A full 3 hours of true capitalist radio. I don't know if it's going to be from 4 to 7, or I don't know if I'm going to start an hour earlier. I'm not sure yet. That's the whole reason why we're going to slowly push out the third hour. I might even have a poll on my Twitter account on whether or not we should have a third hour in the beginning and start it early from 3 to 6 Central Standard Time, or add the hour at the end from 4 to 7 p.m. I leave that up to you, but we're going to, you know, add the third hour for everybody to listen to on the live broadcast here in about a week and a half. All right? Seriously, straight up. Yeah, that's what we're doing. All right? So everybody can listen in. All right? Anyway, folks, let me go ahead and take some quick calls here. I don't want to stay here too long. All right? I don't want to stay here too long. It's a Taco Tuesday. I might go have some tacos to celebrate Taco Tuesday. Might have some fajitas or carne asada. Have you ever heard of carne asada? Carne asada is pretty goddamn good. It's pretty good stuff, man. You should try that stuff, you know, with a little flour tortilla, a little carne asada, man. I'm telling you, man. Hey, look, I'm a cultured man here, all right? I'm cultured. All right, I eat Mexican, all right? I mean, the last time I was at a Mexican restaurant, I had something called, what is it, a chile relleno, a chile relleno, and I don't know what the hell it was. It looked like they stuffed a bunch of garbage into damn green pepper. It was actually rather good, but, you know, yeah, I mean, I'm cultured, baby, I'm cultured. I mean, that's what you people need to understand, baby. I'm not some moron, you know. I'm a cultured man. Anyway, let's move on. I'm only going to take a few more callers. Get the hell out of here, and we'll be back tomorrow, Wednesday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time, baby. You understand that? All right. Who else do we got going on over here? How about Anonymous Radio Graffiti? Did we want to hear you sigh, you fat son of a bitch? We can hear the fat in your windpipe. Jesus Christ, why don't you get that son of a bitch extracted, for Christ's sake, surgically extracted. We can hear, I mean, get that fat surgically extracted from that windpipe, boy. Jesus Christ, who else we got? We got another Anonymous Radio Graffiti.
I'm going to put my big fat Johnson inside. Goes. Yes, 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 I freaking love this.
Yeah, you sick son of a bitch. I mean, you guys are sick with these goddamn splices, man. There's something wrong inside your stupid heads, man. I'm telling you, no fatherly influence. This is what this all comes down to, all right? You leave daddy out of the home, and you leave them to be raised by some dirty dish rag whore single mother. This is the consequence. Some sex-filled, sex-crazed mind, just like Mammy, because when they used to see Mammy go to the happy hour looking for Alabama Black Snake or something that looks good with a leather jacket, slick back hair, chewing on a toothpick, flipping a nickel, this is where these kids saw their mammy act, and they got this sexual infatuation. It's disgusting. It's disgusting, man. I'm telling you this right now. I'm not joking around. I blame single, dirty, dish rag whore mothers for the degradation and the absolute pussification of the American male. I knew this was going to happen, folks. I said this in 2008.
I said this in 2008, for Christ's sake, that the utter pussification, the absolute pussification of the American male was being implemented right before our very eyes, and by God, we are seeing it right now. I mean, folks, I've said this before. I mean, I have to get out of Austin, Texas. I mean, you got assholes out here, these fruity little over-feminized physical attribute fruits, all right, actually wearing legging jeans. I'm talking about jeans that are almost skin tight, for Christ's sake. You can see anal camel toe. You can see anal camel toe. I mean, good God. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. I don't even know why I don't even know why I keep doing this show. I don't get it. I don't know, but what the hell? What the holy hell? Jesus Christ. Anonymous Radio Graffiti. Boat 73, Radio Graffiti. Boat, let me try to dissect that particular splice. Is that, did I hear this correctly? Like some kind of, I forgot who sang the music component of that song. But I think the vocals are coming from that fat bastard, John Popper, from the Blues Traveler. That's what that sounds. I'm trying to figure out the first, I forgot the music. I can't believe it. You caught me off guard there. I can't believe it, for Christ's sake. You know what I'm saying? But once again, you know, here we are once again, all right? Musical blasphemy by Boat. Jesus Christ, man. Anyway, folks, let me continue going, for Christ's sake, man. All right, I'm going to take a couple of more callers, get the hell out of here, all right, and kick back. All right, so, yeah, I got to process more orders today from the Ghost Inner Circle. And, folks, if you've paid and I haven't followed you, please email the Twitter name you want me to follow and, moreover, the license key, all right? If for whatever reason, to the email address that's on your digital receipt, and if you haven't received your digital receipt, look in your spam, all right? Seriously, I'm not joking around. If for whatever reason I haven't followed you or whatever the crap you paid, and look, there are a lot of folks that paid, and they don't even want to be followed. They don't even have a Twitter account, and, I appreciate that. As a matter of fact, I'm considering just putting everyone who is a part of the Inner Circle on an email list so that I can just go ahead and contact everybody in the email list, so it'll be a lot easier to contact, because there's a lot of folks that don't want to really have anything to do with Twitter. And look, I don't blame them, to be honest with you. I mean, Twitter is kind of ridiculous, to say the least. But once again, folks, if you have not been followed by yours truly, and you're out here, and it's already paid, and you are a member, please email the email address on your digital receipt and email the Twitter account and, of course, your license key, please, all right? I'll be, once again, processing transactions later on this evening, all right? Yeah, Elton John, that's who it was, Elton John. Thanks, Boat. Although, it sounded like that Blues Traveler in it. Did you do something to the voice of Stevie Ray? It sounded like that John Popper from Blues Traveler. You know what I mean? Once upon a time, a midnight dreary, and I hear a ha-ha-ha-ha-ha. You know what I'm saying?
That's right, Elton John. I'm not a big Elton John fan. I mean, the only Elton John song that I kind of like, whenever somebody plays it at the bar, is Benny and the Jets. Da 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 da. Bow 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 bow. Benny and the Jets. Bow 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 bow. Anyway, I'm sorry. I'm getting off keister. Let's get some more callers here, all right? I'm getting off keister, but hey, all right. I mean, you know, I'm trying to guess the song here. Anonymous, Radio Graffiti.
Top guy, let's get into a three-way with Mouse Pony. We can change each other's diapers after we're done. It'll be totally legit. Oh, yeah.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Now we got a poor man's tub guy going on here, huh? Is that what we got here? Well, at least he's trying to rip off a personality. I'll give him that. All right? I'll give you that much. All right? At least you're making an attempt to try to have a goddamn personality, for Christ's sake. All right? I'm not joking around. I'm not kidding. And, I'm just going to keep going, all right? I don't know what else to say. I'm speechless, for Christ's sake, man. How about 727, Radio Graffiti?
Hey, Ghost, what's going on? Happy Taco Tuesday. I'm here with my friend Eddie right now. Eddie, you want to talk at all?
Oh, yeah. Hey, Ghost, what's up?
Hey, what's going on, man? Good to hear you fellas. How y'all doing on this Taco Tuesday, man?
Hey, we're doing fine, Ghost.
We're doing good. I don't know if you heard my messages. I know we talked a bit, but, yeah, this is the guy that kind of wanted to get the Ghost Inner Circle, but he can't really afford it. So I just got a quick question for you. Do you know if you'll be giving them out randomly or to, like, certain people?
No, as a matter of fact, I'm glad you asked that question, man. I am actually going to be holding a contest for this and also the first signed cans, and that's going to be happening here next week, all right? Now, I'm trying to put together the contest where everybody has the means to be able to, you know, either construct something, be creative, or some kind of contest of some sort, where everybody kind of has a semi-even keel field as it relates to this. But I want everybody to give everybody the opportunity to be able to win their slot on into the Ghost Circle. You know, as well as I, you know, I try to respond to everybody's private messages now. All right, these are my friends, man. This is the Ghost Circle. These are my friends. And I'm telling you this right now, folks. This Ghost Circle thing, this has nothing to do, first of all, with any of the activity that was conducted back when I was partaking in voice chat room sessions back in 2012. I actually want to get in. I want to get close with some of these people. And I want to talk to them, want to see where they're at in life, see if we can all network together or network with one another or each other to be able to help progress our lives. I mean, that's the whole reason why people are successful. People are successful because they network. You understand? It's not what you know, it's who you know. All right? I mean, you can know everything, but if you don't know the person that's going to help you be the rich person you want to be, you ain't going to get it. I mean, case in point, Bill Gates. Now, Bill Gates, folks, he had the opportunity to meet with the board of IBM, or actually the CEO of IBM. And the only reason that he was able to meet with the CEO of IBM was because his mother sat on the board of IBM. And since Bill Gates dropped out of Harvard, which, you know, his parents were very much in opposition of, and decided to open up Microsoft, at first in New Mexico, of all places, because he was actually working with a hardware manufacturer out of there creating software for that hardware manufacturer, he actually got the meeting with IBM before he even had the DOS operating system. So let me tell you what Bill Gates did. Bill Gates pre-sold DOS operating system to like a million computers that were produced by IBM. And that's what set off the billion-dollar roll into the richest man in the world, which is now what Bill Gates currently is. He sold something that he didn't even have, all right? Now, what did he do? Because he was such into the computer circle and the programming circle and so on and so forth, he knew a guy in Florida, of all places, that actually programmed his own operating system because he was bored. This man was so brilliant, so smart, he programmed his own operating system for fun. So what Bill Gates did, he decided to send his right-hand man, Paul Allen, which is the second richest, or I don't know if he's the second richest anymore, folks, because, you know, Warren Buffett, Carlos Slim, these characters are making billions. And Paul Allen, on the other hand, is kind of, you know, taking the high road. Well, I shouldn't say the high road, but he's living life, all right? You know what I'm saying? I mean, he's living life out here. He owns the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Paul Allen. He owns every goddamn sports franchise out of Seattle, with the exception of any basketball team. He owns the Portland Trail Blazers as it relates to the basketball team. So this guy's, he's living it up, old Paul Allen, all right? But Bill Gates sent Paul Allen, which was at one time the second richest man in the world next to Bill Gates, he sent Paul Allen to Florida to give this son of a bitch who made the DOS operating system that Bill Gates already pre-sold to IBM, he gave this son of a bitch $20,000, and the moron who actually created the operating system was beside himself. He couldn't believe that somebody wanted his operating system for 20 grand. So he took the money, and then lo and behold to him, he helped make freaking Bill Gates a billionaire off of a measly 20 grand. True story, absolute true story. And that's why I'm trying to tell you folks, it's not what you know, it's who you know. Because if I was that son of a bitch that created the DOS operating system and got taken by Bill Gates for a 20,000 spot, when this son of a bitch took my operating system and made himself billions, I would, you know, do Harry Carey right away. I could not live with myself. I'm serious. I couldn't do it. I could not do it. And secondly, folks, another reason why Bill Gates was able to become a billionaire, now, it wasn't just, it was not just the, it wasn't just the sale of DOS to IBM. It actually put, you know, Bill Gates as a player in the software market, which caught the attention of one Steve Jobs. Now, Steve Jobs thought that he was going to manipulate Bill Gates, and how he was going to do that was he wanted to lease out certain software that Microsoft had to Apple computers. The software in question, I believe, was Microsoft Office. Now, the reason Steve Jobs did this is because he wanted to keep, to be honest with you, I really don't know why Steve Jobs did it. I mean, literally, it was to his detriment, to his demise. Because what that did, that allowed Bill Gates to have access to Apple headquarters, Apple research and development, Apple everything. I mean, literally, Bill Gates had carte blanche going in and out of Apple when Apple was the kingpin of the computer industry back in the early 90s. Now, what Bill Gates found was that the graphic user interface component to computing, meaning the point-and-click technology that enables many of us today to peruse the internet, to point-and-click, to activate applications, programs, so on and so forth, this particular graphic user interface was actually first created by Xerox. And Xerox put all this money into the research and development of the first mouse-based graphic user interface system that they thought they wasted a bunch of cash. And look, Xerox is stupid. I mean, their money was in copy machines, and they were so narrow-minded they could not see the future of a graphic user interface computer system. So what they did is they took the research and development and sold it to Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs takes the graphic user interface system and then translates that into the first Macintosh. Okay? The first Macintosh. Now, because Bill Gates was integral into the aspect of Apple and Apple headquarters, and I mean, he was literally able to just kind of go in and out because he was subcontracted. He was licensed by Steve Jobs for Microsoft Office and other applications. Bill Gates saw the graphic user interface system, and he saw that he could apply graphic user interface system and the mouse application integrated with his DOS operating system. Now, let me explain this, because this is very important, because this is what made people billions of dollars, okay? This is what made people billions of dollars. Now, Bill Gates saw that this graphic user interface, in being able to search through your computer instead of having to know command line, which is what DOS is, that's why you have to know all these DOS little commands, much like Unix systems, so on and so forth. The graphic user interface revolutionized computers. And you see, what Steve Jobs was doing, he was trying to monopolize the whole computer industry. You see, and look, they're still like that to this day. You see, if you're going to buy an Apple product, everything in that computer is manufactured and calibrated by Apple, all right? I mean, literally. That's why you have to buy Apple-specific software, Apple-specific hardware, Apple-specific peripheries, because Steve Jobs wanted to monopolize the computer industry. That was his quest. That's what he wanted to do. Bill Gates, on the other hand, saw that the money was not in monopolizing the whole computer industry. The money was in monopolizing the operating system itself. And if you can create an operating system that is graphic user interface that he stole, that he straight up stole from Apple, and if he integrates this graphic user interface with this new operating system called Windows 95, and you are able to calibrate that operating system to work with almost any computer that you have a license with, and of course they were selling licenses by the time Steve Jobs caught wind that Bill Gates had ripped him off of his graphic user interface system and was selling Windows to NEC, IBM, Hewlett Packard, Packard Bell. All those computer industry, he got them all. That's what made him a billionaire, man. Windows 95 made him the richest man in the world, and he had nothing to do with any of that shit. Excuse my French, he had nothing to do with any of it. He literally stole everything, for Christ's sake, man. He stole it all. He stole DOS from that poor son of a bitch geek out there in Florida, and he stole the graphic user interface system from Steve Jobs. So once again, that's Bill Gates right there. That's how this man became a billionaire. That's how come he's the richest man. He made a he turned himself into the richest man selling nothing. I mean, essentially, I'm not joking. All because he knew people, and he knew how to get into places, even if it was his mammy on the damn board of IBM. I mean, he still has to make the sale to the CEO of IBM. He still has to make the sale. You know what I mean? And I know Windows 3 and all that crap. I understand that. I'm saying he didn't make his billions, and he did not basically backstab Steve Jobs until Windows 95. And a good movie, you could probably find this for free on YouTube possibly, is called Pirates of Silicon Valley. It basically tells the story of Steve Jobs, tells the story. Hey, there it is. Thank you very much. Yeah, you took the goddamn words right out of my mouth. Thank you very much, Squid Girl. I appreciate it. There it is. All right, right after this broadcast, you could probably watch that damn movie. It tells the whole tale of Apple and Windows, all right? Jesus Christ. You see, this is why you have to know these things. If you don't know this crap, then you can't blame anybody why you're not in a successful position. You have to know history. You have to know how things turn into play. You have to know how things come together, how it's organized. Do you understand that? Oh, man. And on top of this, I just got a tweet. Homeland Security to take charge of elections. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. I mean, do you see why I got visited by Homeland Security and not the FBI, not Secret Service, not any of these other agencies, but Homeland Security? It all makes sense now, doesn't it? Huh? It all makes sense now, doesn't it? Jesus Christ, Homeland Security to oversee the goddamn election. I mean, what a bunch of horse crap. What a bunch of horse crap, man. I mean, this is not good, folks. This is not good. I mean, did you all see the tweet yesterday that Homeland Security gave? I retweeted that tweet. Something to the effect of, here, let me go look back at it. I want to say what these sons of bitches in Homeland Security exactly said, because it made me want to throw up in my mouth a little bit. I couldn't believe that Homeland Security was saying it. But since these idiots are trying to intimidate me, it makes perfect goddamn sense. Homeland Security, August 29th, okay, at 2:27 p.m., 2016, Homeland Security. This is the United States of America. Taking in refugees at a time of crisis is the right thing to do. Hashtag refugees welcome. I mean, you see this? It makes sense why this goddamn son of a bitch, Homeland Security, is crawling out of my ass. Jesus Christ, man. That's why I said, folks, that this Russian hacking, this supposed Russian hacking of voting machines is pure crap. They are trying to rig the election so that Donald Trump does not win. That's why we have to go out in masses, man. We got to go out in masses like it's a landslide victory. Jesus Christ, man. All right? Jesus Christ. And look, I'm still getting tweets that people weren't able to listen to the broadcast today. I mean, get it straight, Blog Talk Radio. I can't work like this. I can't work like this. Good God. All right, folks. Let me just calm down. You got all kinds of news coming on, man. All right? You got all kinds of news, for Christ's sake, man. Jesus Christ. So what do you see happening if Trump landslides popular vote, but Clinton still wins the electoral vote? Man, I can tell you that they're going to have a serious problem. All right? They're going to have a serious problem because it's not just Trump people. I mean, you got Bernie people that are still scorned. All right? That are still scorned by the goddamn election in California. The robbery of Uncle Bernie. Even though Uncle Bernie doesn't care, he just purchased himself a new freaking summer home, his third. He doesn't care. Oh, man, this is horrible news now, man. Look, I wanted to take a couple of more callers here, but, folks, Homeland Security taking control of the elections, for Christ's sake? This is unprecedented. This is unprecedented, man. I mean, people need to throw a stink about this right now, all right? Seriously, you need to call your congressman and start telling them to freaking wake up, for Christ's sake, man. We do not want a rigged election. We don't want UN observers. We don't want Homeland Security. I mean, we don't want this crap, man. Oh, my God. You know, it gets worse and worse, all right? It just gets worse and worse, doesn't it? Homeland Security. I told you folks, right? Hey, the idiots that came up to me, what did I tell you? Homeland Security, not FBI, not Secret Service, no. Homeland Security. I'm telling you, that Homeland Security needs to be busted open. They need to, you know, they need to be defunded. That was a grotesque addition to the intelligence community. It is a Gestapo as far as I'm concerned, and I think that it should be unfunded and disbanded by Trump when he's elected president. I mean, what a bunch of crap. What a bunch of crap, man. I mean, tell you, what a way to ruin a Taco Tuesday. You've got Homeland Security to take charge of elections. They're going to help rig the son of a bitch. They're going to help rig the goddamn son of a bitch, man. Man, this pisses me. Get this mic out of my head. Damn it. God damn it. They're going to rig the goddamn election. They're going to go. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. I mean, this is horrible news, folks. I'm telling you this right now. This is horrible. Horrible news. Horrible!
A Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty. And there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time.
Oh, my God. Give me the mic. Give me the mic. Hey, I'm going to talk to you supposed liberals, you supposed Bernie Sanders fans, for Christ's sake. I mean, look at all this unprecedented things that are happening. Look at all the opposition to Trump on a global scale, on the political scale. Both the establishment Republicans and the Democrats are trying to sabotage this man. You've got Homeland Security now that wants to rig the election to sabotage this man. I'm telling you, what more does it take for you people to understand that Donald Trump is the only anti-establishment candidate? The only anti-establishment candidate. My God, get it through your heads. All right, stop being so politically ignorant. The only anti-establishment candidate right now that is running for president is Donald Trump. And I don't know what it's going to take to get it through your damn liberal heads that this liberal Democratic Party doesn't care about you anymore. LGBT, it doesn't care about you anymore. Islam supersedes your importance. All right? Same thing with the black folks. All right? Islam and Syrian refugees supersede your importance. Don't you understand that? I mean, did you hear Bill Clinton? They found a clip of him in January talking at the Clinton Foundation, that stupid, ridiculous global initiative garbage, where he says, and I quote, Syrian refugees should rebuild Detroit. That's right. Bill Clinton said that, boy. He said that maybe Syrian refugees should rebuild Detroit. I mean, don't you people understand that? And I'm glad that Donald Trump is going to go to Detroit this Labor Day weekend, and he is going to appeal to the black community one more time and tell them that they have been had, they have been hoodwinked, and the reason that they're in a precarious, poor situation today is because of this supposed black president that you elected into power that was supposed to give you something but gave you nothing but grief, poverty, and the chains of bondage to be dependent on government. With welfare, with housing voucher programs, free child care. These are chains of bondage. These are chains of slavery. And that's why the government wants as many people on that program as possible, because when they control what you eat, when they control where you live, when they control your health care, that is the ultimate capstone of communism. Don't you understand that? You are now a product of dialectic materialism philosophy. And don't you ever forget that, folks. That's why I continue to do the show, man. We have to make sure that Donald Trump's elected. We got to do whatever it takes. I mean, that's why I'm doing shows every day, for Christ's sake. I'm dedicating hours of my life. I'm putting myself at risk. I'm putting myself in genuine risk, for Christ's sake. But if I do nothing, then I am nothing. If you do nothing, then you are nothing. Oh, my God. It's getting dangerous, folks. All right? This is getting dangerous. Oh, my God. I mean, you people need to realize the only anti-establishment candidate right now is Donald Trump. And if you're going to vote for Gary Johnson, and if you're going to vote for Jill Stein, you are wasting your vote. Just stay home. They're not even on the ballot in a lot of states, you idiots. Just stay home. You're just wasting your time. Wax your carrot. Watch a goddamn MTV and just shut your stupid mouth, all right? If you're not going to vote for Donald Trump, then stay home, all right? Seriously. Jesus Christ. I'm serious, you stupid morons. If you're not going to vote for Donald Trump, then you're anti-American, and I'll say it, and I'll keep saying it to your stupid testes, taste-testing, squirrel-fisting, pud-pulling, monkey-spanking face. I'll keep saying it, boy. I'll keep saying it. Jesus Christ. Anyway, folks, I mean, this is bad news. You know, Homeland Security, who's already got me under surveillance, now is going to take control of the goddamn elections. This is bad news. You need to start, you know, tweeting at your congressman, tweeting at your senator, telling that you are completely against this, that the American public is completely against this, and that they should do something about it to stop it. Homeland Security taking control. This is unprecedented, man. This is unprecedented. That whole Russian hacked into the freaking elections, false flag. I knew it was. They were trying to incept the idea of a rigged election. They're already doing it. Here, let me take my goddamn last drink before I get the hell out of here, for Christ's sake. Anyway, folks, I'm going to be back tomorrow, okay? I'm going to go out here for about an hour or two, try to get some dinner. Probably get myself a steak because I love steak. New York Strip, Oak Smoked, woo! Or, of course, a porterhouse, depending on how hungry yours truly is. But, of course, yeah, probably going to be a porterhouse, you know, give the damn T-bone to Templeton over here. Oh, look, he got his head up right when I said T-bone. Anyway, folks, I'll be processing more transactions tonight, folks. If you have ordered and you're not followed yet, please email the email address on your digital receipt. How many more slots do we have left there, engineer? We've got 2 slots left. Good God! Only 2 slots left? I mean, good God! Oh, my God. Anyway, folks, I, first of all, I'm really surprised that the Ghost Inner Circle went so quickly. And not to mention, I genuinely cherish all the emails that I'm getting and the stories. I mean, literally, that's the whole reason why I do this broadcast, man. And it's those stories that inspire me, you know, that give me such inspiration to continue to do things at all costs, no matter what. Because that's what life is all about. Inspiring others, sparking synapses, spreading ideas. That's why I'm saying, folks, each and every one of those emails are very sentimental to me, and I want to thank you all for sharing your stories with me. I'm talking about the Inner Circle. And, of course, folks, if you're not a part of the Inner Circle, you're still a part of the Capitalist Army. The Ghost Inner Circle is more of a personal situation with Ghost. The Capitalist Army is about the cause, baby. You understand what I'm saying? It's about the cause. And the cause is capitalism or death, baby. All right? True capitalist till the soul, till the bullet hole. True capitalist till the soul, till the bullet hole, baby. Well, that's what it's all about. Anyway, folks, I'm going to be back here tomorrow for a Wednesday edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. Of course, I broadcast live every Monday through Friday, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time, the official website, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. That's blogtalkradio.com/ghost. Every one of my episodes is time-dated and stamped. And, of course, they're free to download as well, folks. As a matter of fact, I want to thank a Ghost Inner Circle member, Mark Montag, excuse me, for tweeting at me saying that he remembers when I said, actually predicted the Iranian nuclear deal back in 2009. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I actually predicted this crap. That's what I'm saying. Go back to the archive, man. All the prognostications, all the knowledge. I mean, it's unbelievable. It's unbelievable. All right, it's unbelievable. I mean, the prognostications, man. Go look back at it. If you think I'm lying, go look back. blogtalkradio.com/ghost. And, of course, if you haven't already done so, please follow me on Twitter, folks. The Twitter name to follow is PoliticsGhost. All one word, no underscores. PoliticsGhost is the name to follow. Man, I'm telling you, Homeland Security overseeing this voting process is, I'm telling you, they are going to rig the election, folks. They are going to rig it for Hillary Rotten Clinton, and we need to keep our eyes glued to this situation, to say the least. All right? I'm not kidding around. We need to keep our eyes glued to this situation because something is afoot, and I think people need to make a big stink about it. I think people need to tweet their congressman, write their congressman, call their congressman, and tell them to stop this. Tell them to stop it. This is unprecedented. Russian hackers. I mean, is that what people are going to do now? They're just going to blame Russian hackers? Like Russia is like this cyber Superman? Get the F out of here, man. Seriously, look, I know there's some smart people in Russia. Believe me, I talked to some smart hackers from Russia. I mean, I know that there's some smart people. But let me tell you something. You know what the Russian hackers really want? They want money. They're not after giving away information. Are you kidding me? I mean, the majority of Russian hackers are affiliated with the Russian mafia, okay? I mean, it's about money. It's about getting credit card information and burning that up. It's about getting access to accounts, to bank accounts, routing numbers. You know what I'm saying? This kind of thing. They don't care about releasing information. They don't care about the election. Why in the hell would Russia give two rat's asses about the election? Seriously. They could care less. Especially Russian hackers, man. I mean, they're making these Russians out to be like super hackers. Like they're, I mean, give me a break, man. Give me a break. Give me a damn break. Oh, my God. I'm serious, man. I mean, like they're freaking super hackers, man. Anyway, folks, I'm going to get the hell out of here. I will be back tomorrow once again, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. Be here, and hey, spread the word around like wildfire. All right, we got all kinds of buttons right next to the player, right in front of your face right there. Facebook like buttons, retweet this button, share this buttons. Use and abuse those buttons, baby, all right? It's just a freaking click, man. Spread it around. Anyway, I'm getting the hell out of here. Thank you very much for tuning in with me. Follow me on Twitter, folks, PoliticsGhost, all right? Long live the capitalist army, and death to feminism, death to socialism, death to communism, and death to totalitarianism. What's going on, Templeton? What's going on? You want a T-bone? You want a T-bone, boy? Oh, he wants a T-bone. Look at you hear me. Why are you crying all the time? Why are you crying all the time? Come on, be a tough dog. Why are you crying all the time? Why don't you be a tough dog? Come on. Be a tough dog. All right, we'll get a damn T-bone. He's more worried about it. All right, he's more worried about his damn stomach than anything else. Once again, folks, be here tomorrow, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time, and we will meet again, once again, right here on True Capitalist Radio. I am the Underground, baby. I'm out of here. Hey, what is your problem? Oh, my God. Are you kidding? You're sounding like a baby. You're sounding like a baby. Are you kidding me? Are you a baby? Are you a baby? Oh, my God, Templeton. Stop being a baby. Stop being a baby. Give me a break. Anyway, oh, it looks like we just sold out, folks, of the capitalist, or excuse me, the ghost circle. We just sold out. I want to thank everybody who purchased the ghost circle. Once again, it means a lot, to say the least, all right? And, of course, I didn't raise the price, all right? I mean, I'm not doing this for the money. I'm not going to raise the goddamn prices. Of course, everybody sold out at that price. That's the way it is. Anyway, my goddamn dog's crying over here because he wants a T-bone. All right, he loves T-bones. Right? You like T-bones there, Templeton? You like T-bones? Stop crying. I don't want to hear you crying. Anyway, I'm getting the hell out of here, folks. All right, we're going. Calm down. All right, sit your ass down right there. Good boy. I'm getting out of here, folks. I'll see you tomorrow, 4 p.m. Central Standard Time. You better be here. You better be here. All right. You better be here. I'm out of here.
When you don't go to Geico.com, car insurance can seem intense. Like breakup R&B intense.
I thought you said you loved the sweater that I got you. If you didn't, you could have told me.
Geico makes it easy. Just go to geico.com anytime to update or check your policy without all the extra drama.
I even had a gift receipt.
A Wendy's Frosty is something special. And for a limited time, a Frosty is just 50 cents. An American classic for a classic price. It's not quite a milkshake, not quite an ice cream cone. It's definitely chocolate or vanilla. That choice is on you. Use a spoon or a French fry. Anything goes. A Frosty makes summer special. Yep, there's nothing quite like a Frosty. And there's nothing quite like this deal. A Frosty for 50 cents. Get yours before this deal melts away. Small Frosty at participating Wendy's for a limited time.